Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio. Trade in and trade up to a new Kia for less with one of the area's largest selections of new Kias available. This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
It's time to wake up and let the weirdness begin.
It's the KBJ show.
Just start your morning.
Kevin is the host.
And his skin pigment is whiter than Casper the Ghost.
Virginia.
Sounds like this.
Nickname Vicious Beast.
So don't get her pissed.
It's Jason.
Talks like a spaz.
And he loves to talk about Bigfoot and stats. So get ready. Here we go. You're listening to 97.9 with the KBJ show.
All right. What is going on? Hello and happy Wednesday. Welcome to the KBJ show. How the heck is everybody?
Yeah.
Good to see you all.
Yay. Happy hump day to you.
Yes, I know. Big old hump day today. Trying to get through it here. All right. Well, we got KBJ TV. It is already up and cranking. If you'd like to watch us, just go to YouTube. Look for the KBJ show.
Speaking of KBJ TV, look at Kevin's shirt. Remember those paintings back in the day when we were kids? You would look at them, and if you looked at them long enough, it would make an image.
A wizard would pop out.
Yeah, or there'd be some kind of, gingerbread house. You've got a shirt like that I want to just stare for hours.
Well, drink it in, baby. It's right there. You can go and stare and get mesmerized by my shirt.
Another fantastic brunch shirt.
Yes, it is. Yes, from the Express Collection.
We have a big meeting today, but I say we skip the meeting and go to brunch instead.
No, I'm wearing this for the meeting, so that's
it's
the
funny.
Reason why.
That's what you're wearing to the meeting. This is what I'm wearing to the meeting.
Yeah, you know what? We all got our business attire.
This is why it works, baby.
This is monkey business.
All right, you can dial it up. The shortcut, kbjshow.tv to watch.
What are you thinking about? What are you thinking about?
What's on your mind?
Are you thinking about? What are you thinking about?
All right, what you got on your mind today, Jay Bird?
Well, I thought the witch said something pretty poignant the other day when she had said something along the lines of, I like looking forward to things throughout the week. And I think a lot of people don't do that enough. Even if it's small, even if it's big, whatever it is, you got to look forward to something on this planet. Am I right?
That's why I love having a calendar. You are so right. Because I write down all the fun things coming up, and then I look in the calendar, and I'm like, ooh, that's going to be fun. Ooh, that's going to be fun. And it gets me all excited.
I get excited about really dumb, goofy, stupid things. And for whatever reason, the whole dinosaur garden got me very excited.
Okay.
It kind of happened on a weird night. It was right before the Halloween party. And I felt like I didn't have enough think pieces for the party.
Okay.
And I looked out in the backyard and I go, dang, man, that place is empty over there on that side. And Twigs and Bigfoot from the snack pad said, dog, you need something big to go up there, like a dinosaur. And I go, holy crud balls, my boy sells dinosaurs. And then the whole thing kind of
just snowballs.
Yeah. And then it turned into this weird project with my friends and with my family that kind of turned magical. Something goofy on a whim turned into this awesome DIY project. And then the final piece finally came in last night.
Okay.
My family got together and bought me a pterodactyl.
Wow.
And it's the one.
That's how they go all in.
Yeah, it's the one that's going to bring it all together, and I'm very excited, and the video will be done probably in the next week, because the pterodactyl is going to take a little time to put up, but I bring this up because yesterday I get a knock on the door, it's around 5:30 p, it's a mother and her two kids. Hey, Jay, but we're in the neighborhood. Can we see your dinosaur garden? Randomly.
Really? Just out of nowhere, they knock on the door?
Yes, and I felt dinosaur insecure because it wasn't ready yet, but I did let them see it.
That is nice of you.
But the point of this whole dinosaur rant is it's the small things in life. Get something goofy. Get obsessed with it. And you'll see yourself really enjoying life.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it is fun. You do need to have a little side project, a nice little distraction, something that you look forward to.
Something that invokes passion in you. Whether it's people get it or not, get passionate about something. I think that's an exciting thing about life.
Yeah, people don't have to get it for it to be valuable.
People get all passionate about stupid things. Get passionate about something smart, like a dinosaur garden.
That's right.
How big is your pterodactyl?
You know what? I haven't even got it out of its Jurassic Park box. I would say it's the size of Kevin's head to his pelvic bone.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
It's the centerpiece.
Three quarters of Kev?
Little less than 3/4 of calf.
It's a decent amount. It's a good size.
Yeah.
No doubt.
Does it look as good as Kev?
Nope. Does not have awesome hair.
Not a chance.
Will you put a little wig on it and call it Kevin the Pterodactyl?
You know what? I am open to making this thing an evolving. Just, yeah, I love it. I'm into it. I'm into it all, honestly.
All right, Virginia, what do you got on your mind today?
I think I have perfected a cornbread recipe, and I am so proud of it, and I really never did a lot of cornbread, but I bought that Jiffy mix, and I love doing this, where you take like a mix, but you do your own thing to it. So instead of just adding eggs and water and making it like it says on the box, I doubled the eggs. I added heavy cream instead of water.
Okay.
And then I put seasoning, and then I put a bunch of chunks of habanero cheese in it. And it is so good.
Okay.
I'm going to bring some in for you guys, and I'm really going to work on perfecting this cornbread recipe. Panda had some more last night, and he's like, this is the best cornbread I've ever had.
Wow.
That's a big, because Panda loves his cornbread. Mine isn't like loose where it falls apart. Mine is spongy and moist, and it stays together. There's no crumbs.
Because I feel like you can go too wet.
You can.
Which sounds weird coming from a guy who loves wet food, and you can go too dry.
You absolutely can.
But find that sweet spot.
I think I found the sweet spot. I think this is my next new thing. I'm going to get really good at cornbread.
And the cool thing about cornbread, you can do so many different little subsets of cornbread.
I know.
You can.
I'm going to make a crawfish cornbread.
You could do a cornbread type of crust for a pizza.
Totally.
Why not?
Kevin, the possibilities with cornbread.
I'm not going to lie. The ideas are just kind of flowing right now.
Yeah, free forming.
It's Wednesday. I don't know.
Maybe I'll make a cornbread-shaped pterodactyl.
Oh, my. All right.
Oh, no, yeah.
Okay, stop.
Now she's just messing with you.
Because if it doesn't happen, I'll be broken.
I didn't mean to turn you on so hard.
What I got on my mind here today, man. How did you wake your kids up? It is a challenge, man, when you want to get going in the day. And that's kind of it, because we got the whole crew. Like our family, we take off, we go in the morning, and, you know, kind of sometimes getting a teenager up and moving at a faster gear, it is a tough thing to do. And so we're trying to figure that out. And I know when I was a kid, my mom had a thing, because she was a teacher, and she did not play. And so I do what a lot of teenage boys like to do. You don't want to wake up. She'd turn on the light and all that kind of stuff. After the third time my mom came in, she would come in with a full cup of ice water, and it would go right in my face.
Ooh.
And she was like, you awake now? She'd be like, you better get going. I got more where that comes from. She was like, they're going to get bigger. Yeah, right in my face. She'd come right in, push, right in the face.
I can say, looking back in my life, the only time I really, truly disliked my mother on a core that I couldn't even deal with was when she tried to wake me up for school.
Oh, yeah. No, it's tough, because you don't want to get up and go anyway. You want to sleep a little bit longer. You're a teenage boy. You probably stayed up too late anyway. And bam, there you go. So I was just kind of curious. Yeah, what is your tactic? Do you have anything that you do? Because we had that struggle today, and we're like, okay, well, how do you do it? I'm like, well, I don't know if you want to do it, Kim, but this is what my wife did. Because I'm like, we got to just wake Cannon up earlier. And they're like, well, we are. We're trying.
I don't know. I don't know if doing what your mom did is the right way.
Her other plan was to just leave him and not have him go to school.
That would be awesome for
Cannon.
That's
not a good idea either.
Exactly. So that's what I'm saying. Where is the middle ground? What do you do when a kid is just laying there and they will not get up out of bed?
What
is your strategy? His bedtime.
Shake him. Take away the, what are the kids playing these days?
Take away the phone, all the video games at night. Make him go to bed at 8:00.
Yeah. I think the issue is I go to bed early, crazy early. And so I'm not up to police things. So I think if I'm not up, then things go a little bit late.
When Papa Bear's hibernating.
Yeah, so it's kind of tough because it's not an option. If I stay up, then I'm going to come in here looking like hell every day.
And you're at the age, or Cannon's at the age where he's going to be staying up later the more he gets older.
Yeah, absolutely.
He don't want to go to bed at 9:00.
No.
No, and that's the way it is. That's really kind of the hours. You know, that's the thing that's tough is that, you know, a lot of times they're finding out now teenagers and adolescents, their schedule is not really what the world has them in. In fact, they've even talked about doing schools where kids would be showing up at about 11 a.m. in the morning because they do better. They're not morning people. And so that's the challenge. Yet they're on a morning schedule. So they
got to collective
get up and get going.
Level.
Right.
Yeah, it works against what their body is really biologically wanting to do.
Well, that's the one time in my life being a teenager, I remember sleeping for about 16 hours nonstop going, "Oh, man, this is great."
Yeah.
You can sleep a lot when you're a teenager.
No, you can.
Deeply.
Absolutely. It's tough to do. So yeah, do you have a strategy, because we've got to ratchet it up a notch. So, yeah, because I'm the one, I'm always at the door tapping my feet. I'm like, "I got to go. Y'all hear that music playing?"
Well, let's make it fun. We've done a bunch of those KVJ wake-up calls.
Yeah.
Let me have plug in the electric guitar and wake them up.
Oh, Jaybird wake-ups
would
be fun.
Yeah, why don't you start coming over in the morning then, yeah.
We should do the Jaybird wake-up call. We'll go through 5 or 6 of the ones we've done on the air to Cannon.
Yeah, okay.
Firecrackers in a metal trash can.
I'm cool with it.
Oh, I would love to wail on a guitar waking Cannon up.
All right. Come to my place tomorrow morning.
Let's do it, dog.
All right, it's done.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
February is fun at Seminole Casino, Coconut Creek. Hey there, it's Randy West. There is so much going on, including the 2 to 100 times mystery Unity Points Multiplier. That's coming up this Sunday. What a way to celebrate Valentine's Day, right? Maybe at one of the amazing restaurants. And a little fun at Seminole Casino, Coconut Creek. There's so much to choose from. NYY Steak, their Valentine's Day specials with all kinds of Valentine's Day menus, like options like scallops on the half shell, filet mignon. I mean, any Valentine would love it. Then there's Legends Lounge, Sunset Grill. So much fun going on at Seminole Casino, Coconut Creek. We talk about, I'm a slot player, maybe you're a poker player. The elevated poker experience upstairs in Coco's Poker Smoke-Free Room is, bar none, the best. Then let's talk entertainment, like the Beach Boys coming in March, Joan Jett, Sublime with Rome, Aaron Lewis. It's all at Seminole Casino, Coconut Creek. Don't forget to sign up for your Unity card when you visit Seminole Casino, Coconut Creek.
What's better than one slice of pizza from Racetrack to get you going? How about 2 slices of pizza? And when you buy one slice, you can get any other for $1. Ayo, you could buy one slice of pepperoni for now and get the new bacon cheeseburger pizza for later for just $1. Or just get 2 slices for now. Buy one, get one for $1 slices. Get you going. Oh, I like that. We should put that on a t-shirt or something. Racetrack, whatever gets you going. Limited time item only at participating locations.
Injured on the job? It takes one phone call to take back control of your life. Anajar Levine will fight to get you the compensation you deserve. Call me, Glenn Levine, for a free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
In office, West Palm Beach.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Well, hello, Winn-Dixie. And hello, Big Game Savings. Previously frozen pork baby bags, St. Louis style, or spare ribs are BOGO. Touchdown! Oh, my game day faves are on sale too, like snow crab clusters for $10.99 a pound and Hass avocados for 69 cents each. Plus, we're scoring mad points with Winn-Dixie Rewards. Winn-Dixie, it's a win-win. While supplies last, no substitutions or rain checks. Exclusions apply. See stores for details.
For over 35 years, we at Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm, have built our firm with the word more in mind. We have more than 800 lawyers and more offices nationwide ready to fight for you. And to date, we have recovered more than $15 billion for our clients. So, if you've been injured at work or in a car accident, you deserve more. Contact Morgan & Morgan today. Just dial pound law or visit forthepeople.com for an office near you.
So being new here, I can completely understand how moving is just like the most not fun thing on the planet. It's Jeff Miles. You know, life throws you these curveballs. It's how you handle them that can really set you up for success or failure wherever you happen to be headed. When life's doors open, let Open Door handle the house. Selling, buying a home can be one of the most stressful experiences in life. It doesn't have to be, though. You can skip all these hassles. Sell your home directly to Open Door. They will give you an all-cash offer on your house in a matter of days. Listen, I know there's never a perfect time to move, and Open Door can help any time be a perfect time, where you get to take control of your move when you start with Open Door. Choose your closing date to avoid transitional housing and move when it works for your life. Start very simply with a free all-cash offer on your house today at opendoor.com. That's opendoor.com. Open Door is represented by Open Door Brokerage, Inc., license 02061130 in California, and Open Door Brokerage, LLC in its other markets.
At South University West Palm Beach, our grads are job-ready. In our Bachelor of Science in Nursing program, you can gain the knowledge, skills, and hands-on clinical experience you need to pursue your nursing career and make an impact in your community. If you want a program that prepares you for professional success, look no further than South University West Palm Beach. Learn more about our nursing and healthcare programs at southuniversity.edu.
I know it works because I've seen it work with my wife. Sometimes you get to that point in life where your body just has a slowing metabolism and there's really not a lot you can do with it. Maybe a hormone imbalance, and especially when you get close to menopause, it can be really hard to lose the weight. That's why Red Mountain Weight Loss was so key for my wife, getting her metabolism going and her hormones in balance. And it all starts with their RM3, an all-natural hormone that burns fat from your belly, hips, and thighs. You can lose 20 pounds by this time next month with the RM3 from Red Mountain Weight Loss. Imagine getting back to your ideal body weight. You can do it. And all the while eating real fresh food. You're not going to feel starved or deprived, and it's not a stimulant, so you're not going to feel nervous or jittery. Want to jump on it and see the same kind of success my wife did? You can schedule your online consultation by dialing #250 from your cell phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
Hi, I'm attorney Victor Demesman from Demesman and Dover. You guys know I always keep it real, and I'm going to keep it 100. If you've been in an accident, hit us up. No jingles, no fake voices. It's simple. If we don't get you paid, we charge it to the game. Demesman and Dover, 866-954-MORE. That's 866-954-6673. Main office, Fort Lauderdale.
Check out KVJ TV on YouTube or just log on to kvjshow.com to watch the show now. Powered by Cleveland Clinic, where every life deserves world-class care. Now, back to the KVJ Show. On 87.9 WRMF.
We're talking about what do you do to get that teenager out of bed when they just won't. Trying to figure out what we got to do. We got to get a little bit more giddy up in my house. Andre's on here from Port St. Lucie with a pretty interesting idea. What is your thought on how to wake up a teenager when they won't for school, Andre?
Well, I mean, the kid's not going to like it, but you keep some marbles in the freezer and then you toss them in the bed, and no matter where the kid rolls, you can't get away from them. second.
Dang. That's pretty good.
That's very better good than ice water like Kevin's mother threw on him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It stays dry, you know, no water, no mess.
Yeah. Okay.
Pissed off kid standing there like, what
the? I don't hate it, Andre.
It's a good one.
That is a pretty good strategy there. There you go. I might have to go buy some marbles today and get all ready for tomorrow. Well, coming up here in just a couple of minutes, can you believe this? Teenagers are getting scammed more than senior citizens now.
Oh, no.
Right. It's crazy. You know, hey, Florida's always been the scam capital, and it's usually been because of our seniors. But now the teenagers are getting scammed.
I like this hour. We're really going in on the teenagers this hour. I like you.
Yeah. Well, they won't wake up, so we're going to talk about them. Yeah, coming up here in just a second, I will tell you the four different scams they have that are targeting teens. And if you're a parent, you'll definitely want to know about it next.
Running fast along the sand.
To always talk about your grandma and grandpa getting ripped off and scammed here in Florida. We got so many retired people here that they were a big target. But things have been changing over the last couple of years, and now teenagers are falling for more online scams at a higher rate than senior citizens. They say that the money lost by victims under the age of 20 grew over 1,000% over the last 5 years compared to only 390% for senior citizens.
Me and Virginia have said it once. We'll say it again. Don't trust Instagram ads. It's a scam.
Yeah, and don't trust people you meet on the internet when they tell you, oh, I'm your friend and I need to borrow some money, or, hey, I've got this cause, will you please donate? Just be more skeptical.
Or your brother's getting a weird liver operation in South America.
And you know your brother's not in South America.
Honestly, I didn't know.
They say there are four different types of scams that are the most effective against teenagers. The first one is known as sextortion. It is plots against teenage boys where scammers will pose as attractive females on social media. Then they'll send naughty photos and ask for the same in return. And then once they receive them, they'll tell the teenage boy that if he doesn't send money, the photo's going to be sent to all his friends and family and posted online.
That is so sad.
It is, because that's just going to mess with the kid's head in a massive way.
It is. And the only thing I would say is if you really did do it, just own it up to your family. Just be honest with them.
But this is why you never, ever take pictures of yourself and have them on your phone, on your email, anything. Never do it.
But
nude pictures don't belong in your life until you're the age of 21.
And I agree with what the witch is saying.
That's it.
But that's all. I mean, good luck trying to put that genie back in the bottle. It's going to happen. Kids are going to do what they do. And you're right.
I know. But I had the talk with Magnolia. Like, look, here's what's going to happen. Boys are going to ask you for pictures. This is normal. Boys are going to ask your girlfriends for pictures. This is normal. They're just being boys. Your answer is always no. Because that picture will live on forever, and it can be used against you, and it can be shared with school. It can be shared with strange, weird men on the internet. Like, you have no idea how far that picture can go once you take it. So don't take it and put yourself in that position.
It's a good awareness that every kid needs to at least hear. You know, the talk that you need to have with your kids now, it's so much different than the talk my parents needed to have with me back
totally.
In the day.
It is.
Well, there's a new study that says a third of kids don't even care that the fact that they'll, if you tell them you're being stalked by creepsters, like, yeah, I don't care, because they're just still, they're being born in that world. At least that's what the study said. A third don't care.
Yeah.
Damn.
So the other things that people are doing to get scammed is student loan scams. You know, the government had announced that you could get up to $20,000 in student loans forgiven. And so now there's a whole bunch of fake websites trying to look like they're the Department of Education. They even have the logos and everything.
Wow.
And they get people to provide their bank account personal information, saying, oh, yeah, hey, we'll forgive your debt.
We're going to send you money for that right now. Just give us your bank account.
Instead, they scam you and put you in worse financial situations.
They would get me so hard. Even yeah. After you told me that story, they'd still get me.
That's what they say. The only place you should go is yourself. Go to studentaid.gov. When you go there yourself, you know it is legit. And, you know, one thing that I've noticed, too, is whenever you apply for anything from a government agency, a trademark or a business or things like that, you will start getting scam emails right away from people with the same logos trying to say, hey, you need this extra protection or you didn't file it right. Click here to refile because it didn't take. And you have to be like, wait a minute. You have to really do kind of a deep dive.
They're all tricks. It's terrible.
Mm-hmm. They say the third way that teenagers are getting scammed is online gaming. Players are using credit cards to make in-game purchases that'll help them win stuff. So the scammers will pose as fake vendors and they'll send phishing links during in-game chats to make these purchases. And the kids think it's coming from the video game, yet it's a scammer that's just sending them a message. Oh. And if they click on it, they will get access to all of your information.
Oh.
We've probably changed our credit card 20 times because there's always mysterious charges that come up. We're like, Cannon, what's going on, dude?
What is this?
So Cannon will use the credit card and then you guys will get some odd charges that you know are not
I can't
real?
Even confidently say what the path is and what's happening. All I know is I will load up with $50 worth of items and it'll be standing at Publix and they'll be like, sorry, your card doesn't work. I'm like, again?
That's embarrassing.
What's going on? Why does my car never work?
That's so embarrassing.
What are we doing, Kim?
I would be choking a kid.
Oh, man.
That's too far. You can't embarrass me when I'm checking out at Publix like that. And everybody in line thinks you're broke.
And they say the fourth way that scammers are getting teenagers is through talent scout scams.
Rocco got by that.
Yeah, it's on Instagram and TikTok primarily, and you will get a DM offering modeling and acting opportunities. And so they'll ask for a fee to apply, but of course there's no job waiting for you.
Right.
They'll request personal information too during your application process, and then they'll use that to commit identity theft.
The other thing they'll do too, if you are a pet owner, that you're always putting stuff up on Instagram, but I used to do that with Chewy. I'd get all these messages. We want to have your dog be an Instagram model for dog models. Models.net.
And meanwhile, you know your dog ain't that cute.
You better mind your tongue. Uh-huh. Rest in peace, Chewy. Don't you listen to that witch. But it was a scam. I'm just saying.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, there you go. So who would have thought that the teens are getting scammed more than the senior citizens? You're worried about grandma and grandpa, yet you need to be worried about that teenager in your house.
Oh, boy.
Mm-hmm. Crazy stuff. Coming up here in a couple of minutes, Seth Rogen had said that nobody has made a good high school movie since Superbad came out in 2007. Is that really true, though? Have there not been any good type of high school movies in the last 16 years?
About the high school comedy, because Superbad was amazing.
Sure, when we grew up, they had them all over the place. There was Ferris Bueller's and The Breakfast Club and 16 Candles. You know, our whole adolescence was full of these kind of movies, but is he right or is he just aged out of the teenage movie? I'll give you a couple suggestions, and if you got some too, you can let us know. 877-979-WRMF. What is a good high school movie from the last 15 years?
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
Well, at the moment, no major incidents being reported on your roadways. 95 and the Turnpike, both up to speed for the most part throughout Broward and Palm Beach counties. Traffic a service of Palm Beach Mitsubishi. I'm Suits, 979 WRMF.
Like bones, your teeth lose density and become weaker over time, which can lead to tooth decay. And that can make your visit to the dentist feel like this. But if you want your dental visit to feel like this, try Crest Densify. Crest Densify actively rebuilds tooth density to extend the life of teeth by remineralizing enamel. Densify from Crest, the number one toothpaste brand in America. Smile, Crest has you covered.
Before New Cascade Platinum Plus, I would pre-rinse all my dishes because my old detergent just wouldn't get them clean. But now, I do dishes differently. A no pre-wash, no rewash, money-back guaranteed kind of different. Because Cascade Platinum Plus has double the grease-fighting power of Dawn built right in, with twice the scrubbing power, giving me a clean that lets me break all the dish rules. I just scrape, load, and I'm done. Yep, so clean. With Cascade Platinum Plus, I dare to dish differently.
Flanagan's has a sweetheart of a deal. Joe's Meal Deals. Ribs, wings, shrimp, prime rib, tilapia steak with potato or rice, Caesar salad, garlic rolls, and a free beverage. Sunday through Thursday only. Flanagan's offers all brands of liquor, beer, and wine. Up to 50% off. Weekends 11 a.m. till 7 p.m. and every night after 9 p.m. How sweet it is. There's only one place for ribs. Flanagan's. Legendary juicy tender meatballs off the bone baby back ribs and a menu that contains over 50 items that are fresh and homemade. Unbelievable. Flanagan's and Big Daddy's are now hiring for all positions. Flanagan's. Life the way it should be.
Flanagan's is now hiring for our new Miramar location. Prep cooks, line cooks, hosts, servers. Apply online now at flanagans.net.
It's Valentine's Day every day in February at Palm Beach Mitsubishi. Feel the love with huge discounts off MSRP. Cha-ching! You make it to Palm Beach Mitsubishi and we'll make it happen. Palm Beach Mitsubishi, across from the Palm Beach Airport. PalmBeachMitsubishi.com.
Hey, it's Jay Bird. I love donuts. I'm a donut man. That's why I love Dunkin', and they are getting all kinds of ready for Valentine's Day with their pairings. How about this pairing? We got the Dunkin' Brownie Butter Batter Donut with the Cocoa Mocha Signature Latte. That is not easy to say, dog, but it is delicious.
Are they coming up with tongue twisters on purpose for you?
It's not easy to say, but it is easy to eat. Become a DD Perks member. Deals galore, am I right? And Virginia the Witch is drinking out of a Dunkin' cup.
I am. I got a Dunkin' today, and the perks are amazing when you join.
We run on Dunkin'.
Aware Recovery Care is here to help you or your loved ones recover from addiction to drugs and or alcohol. Aware's one-of-a-kind, Yale-inspired in-home addiction treatment model works using a completely different approach to recovery. Our team of specialists treat people where they live and where their triggers live, and it's designed to achieve a full year of recovery, improving your chances for lasting health and wellness by 80%. Let us help you recover where you live. To learn more, visit AwareRecoveryCare.com.
Hey, have you played these new Gold Rush Doubler scratch-offs?
Wait, why does my voice sound like this?
With multiple ways to double your prizes, the winnings are even higher. Guess your voice is just going with it.
Over $540 million in cash prizes and 36 new millionaires. Now I like the sound of that.
New Gold Rush Doubler scratch-offs from the Florida Lottery. Must be 18 or older to play. Play responsibly.
I love the way my windows look. Finally finished up every single window in the house. It really makes such a difference. The house is so quiet now. I'm going to save on my power bill. My insurance goes down. My home value goes up. And the team from BNT brought out the experts. They brought out a team of like seven guys, master installers at BNT that really know their stuff. And they use custom PGT windows and doors. And PGT just makes the best-selling window and door on the market. So when you want the capable, amazing, intelligent, and awesome crew, you gotta call BNT Windows and Doors. They will do it right the first time. Set it up online today at BNTWindowsAndDoors.com.
What does it mean when Art Plumbing, AC, and Electric says no surprises guaranteed? First, it means a photo of your art technician arrives before they do. And it means you get an upfront quote before work begins and that you understand exactly what is needed to get the job done right. It means your plumbing, AC, or electrical problem is fixed with no surprises guaranteed. Art is there with what you need. Art can fix it.
I'm Trey Lytle, a partner at Lytle, Ryder, Smith, Ivey, and Fronrath. My grandfather, Lake Lytle, proudly served our local community as Palm Beach County Commissioner for 32 years. Since 1985, our law firm has been helping those injured both in the courtroom and in the community. My firm is here to help if you or a loved one has been injured. We have recovered over $200 million for our injured clients in the last 3 years alone. Your consultation is always free. Call me at 561-888-8881. When disaster strikes, visit us at foryourrights.com, Main Office, West Palm Beach.
Good Greek, moving and storage. Your superhero movers.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Drive into love with hgregg.com on Military Trail. Whatever your taste or budget is, they've got a huge inventory of vehicles with a perfect match for you and your loved ones to make this Valentine's Day special. hgregg.com. Save more, drive happy.
Warmer Wednesday. Temperatures starting off in the upper 60s and low 70s. Mostly sunny and breezy and warm this afternoon. Highs topping out the low 80s. Tonight's lows in the upper 60s and low 70s. Tomorrow's highs, low 80s. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa for 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Inspire Aesthetics. This Valentine's Day, pucker up with juicy, sexy lips with $100 off a Restylane Kiss Lip Treatment. Call Inspire Aesthetics today at 855-INSPIRE. That's 855-INSPIRE. Or online at InspireAesthetics.com.
What's hot now on the KBJ Show?
You can follow KBJ on social media. Whatever your favorite platform is, we're likely there. We've got Facebook, we have TikTok, we have Instagram, we have Twitter. All you have to do is go to any of those platforms, look for the KBJ Show. You're going to see all kinds of stuff that happens in the studio, out of the studio, at our homes, behind the scenes. It is all there. A different package and a lot of stuff you're not even going to hear on any of the broadcast shows that we do. So just go find your platform and just dial it in your search for KBJ Show.
Get the info on everything that's going on with us at kbjshow.com.
His whole career launched in a teenage movie called Superbad in 2007. And now Seth Rogen is saying that no one's really made a good high school movie since that movie came out. And we're talking 15 years. Is that really true?
It was raunchy, and I think that's what he means. One of those raunchy teenage comedies.
I don't even know, according to a BuzzFeed article, that he's even right. Because they bring up at least 20 different movies they say are quality movies based on teenage life over the last 15 years to prove him wrong. But my question and my thought was, you know, we always do Suits's Gen Z movie reviews, looking at a millennial or Gen X classic, and then he gives a review. I think maybe we need to find a movie and then we need to take it and watch and say, hey, how does old eyes like a new teen comedy or drama, whatever it might be? And then we can review it ourselves. Now, some of these movies they suggest, they do well on Rotten Tomatoes. So they have been reviewed by critics and also fans. And some of the ones to choose from include movies like Booksmart that was directed by Olivia Wilde. I kind of remember when that came out. And that was being billed as, oh my gosh, this is the new raunchy teen comedy. It has a 96 critic score and a 77 fan score on Rotten Tomatoes. Which is not bad.
It's pretty good.
You've got one called Lady Bird with Timothy Chalamet, the actor. It's got a 99 critic score, 79 fan score.
Have you seen either one of those movies?
I have not. I'm bringing up ones that I've not seen. One that I did see that BuzzFeed listed was Blockers. That was the movie that has Leslie Mann and John Cena in it. And there were some funny laugh-out-loud moments, but overall, I wouldn't say it was a good movie. In fact, they only give it a 51 fan score, 84 critics were, so the critics like that better than the fans.
I did see that, and I did not like it.
I didn't either. I agree with the 51. Like I said, a few moments made it amusing, but it wasn't a good movie overall. They actually listed Spider-Man Homecoming, which I guess is fair, because Peter Parker's a teenager.
It's a Spider-Man movie.
Is in there.
Dang, BuzzFeed.
You don't categorize that. Okay.
All right, absolutely not. Right. That is a superhero movie.
Not only do we don't categorize that, we're kind of mad now.
And
I
we
can
wanna
see that.
Fight your list.
Wow.
Yeah. It's terrible, Kevin.
Some of the other ones that they recommend, The Edge of 17 with Hailee Steinfeld. It's got a 94 critic score, 83 with the fans. You've got one called Dope that was produced by Pharrell and Sean Combs. Diddy. Did you know Diddy did a movie called Dope?
I did not.
I did not either.
I knew he did, but I'd never seen it.
Okay.
What's the score on that one?
88 on the critics, 83 on the fans.
Okay. Oh, that, you know what? I saw some of that. That is good. That's a good one.
Okay.
What I saw of that was good.
Okay, that might be one to check out. There's another one called The Way, Way Back. There is Honor Society with Christopher Mintz-Plasse. What's his name? How do you say his name?
I don't know.
I've seen the name before, but I don't know what the kid does. That's an 85 and an 80. There's also one called Easy A that has Emma Stone, Penn Badgley, Amanda Bynes, and Thomas Hayden Church that's got an 85 critic score and a 77 fan score. So there are some out there. So I've got a list. If you guys want, maybe this weekend we can grab one. I kind of want to see maybe Dope.
Dope is good.
Dope or Booksmart.
I want to finish Dope. I did like that.
Yeah. Either one of those two look like the ones that I've got. So what would you say would be a good teen movie that has come out over the last 15 years? You can add to our list right now. Maybe we'll watch it coming up this weekend, let you know we like it. Coming up next on the KBJ Show.
I throw my hands up in the air sometimes, saying, ayo, gotta let go. That's my plans. I'm wearing all my favorite brands. Give me some space for both my hands. Yeah, 'cause it goes on and on and on. And it goes on and on and on, yeah. I throw my hands up in the air sometimes, saying, ayo, gotta let go. Came to move. Get out the way of me and my crew. I'm in the club, so I'm gonna do. Just what you came here to do. Yep, 'cause it goes on.
Trying to prove Seth Rogen wrong that there's not been a good teenage movie made since Superbad in 2007. Some of the ones that people are saying, yeah, it was pretty good. I'm getting good comments about Dope, Booksmart, The Edge of 17, and The Way, Way Back. So people in the chat room have all pretty much given a thumbs up from the comments that I've seen on that. Somebody's asking about the Twilight movies, like saying, well, wouldn't those count? The only thing about the Twilight movies is the first one was made in 2008. So that was the year after Superbad. So that's just on the fringe. And I don't know if you would consider any of those great teenage movies. Maybe you would. And those could qualify.
That's kind of, that's like saying Lost Boys is a teenage movie, and it's not. It's a vampire movie.
Really?
At the end of the day, it's a vampire movie.
I agree with him.
Twilight's a vampire movie. Yeah, it's teenagers, yeah. But...
it's not a high school movie.
Okay. It goes beyond that. So Twilight doesn't count as a high school movie because...
I don't think so.
No. The jury is in. Nope.
Okay. The jury of two is ruled.
Yes.
I was surprised, man. The ratings on the original Twilight aren't great. The critics gave it a 49. Yeah, and the fans only gave it a 72.
Because it wasn't that good, Kev.
Yeah, I knew it wasn't. I thought it was just me. Apparently it's not. All right, so there's some options for you if you want to try out a movie. We'll post that up on our Facebook page. So if anybody's got any other endorsements on that. And you know what? Maybe we can actually take an endorsement from Suits and find out what he would deem to be a classic teenage movie from his generation. And see how we like it.
Good question.
We always give him suggestions.
It wasn't that long ago. He's a teenager 10 years ago.
I wonder if he's seen that movie Election. You know what I'm talking about? With Reese Witherspoon.
I do.
And Matthew Broderick. It's so good.
I wouldn't say it's so good.
I loved it.
It's good. So good.
I loved
Maybe
it.
Maybe not so good.
It's good.
It's so good.
So good. Kevin.
I have never even heard of that movie.
Wow, look
at
you.
Is it the one from, no, is it 2005?
I think so, yeah.
You old?
It's old.
Okay, is it a, the Matthew, no, it's 99.
99, it's even older.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
I was four, so.
It's got a 92 on the tomato meter and a 79 on the audience score.
Yeah, it's a cute, good movie.
It's a
solid.
You think I'd like that one?
No.
Okay.
I also loved High School Musical.
I couldn't get into those as a kid.
So good.
But
Suits.
Even that one, that's old, too.
I know. I'm old. What do you want from me?
You're thinking High School Musical is from 2015, and then you look at the date.
Okay, I do have a current one. Perks of Being a Wallflower. That is good, and that's kind of more current.
There's another one with, it's called Bye Bye Baby.
Uh-huh.
But I don't know what year that is. See, in my head, I think it's 2000, I don't know, 14. Bye Bye Baby. It's a good, really good movie. It's got a teenage element to it. Because there's a big storyline. What year is that?
It says here, and I pulled it up, Google search, it says 1975.
That's not the one.
That seems about right.
No.
I pulled it up, and it says a baby registry.
Bye Bye.
They've got 1989.
I think I'm telling you the wrong title, dog. I'm blowing it.
Yeah, Bye Bye Baby, 1988.
It's got Steve Carell in it, so it can't be that one.
Oh, okay.
I'm giving you
2001. Maybe is another one.
I mean, you made fun of my Election, really? Bye Bye Baby.
Is the one from 2001? That's the Steve Carell one?
I don't know.
I mean, not any of these movies even ring a bell that you guys are talking about.
We had you watch Ferris Bueller, right?
Well, I saw that one. I saw beforehand.
Saw okay,
yeah,
okay,
it's tough to go through life and not see Ferris Bueller.
Because that's a classic.
Yeah.
I mean, if you don't have 16 Candles and Ferris Bueller under your belt, you're living wrong.
Yeah, I've seen both of those movies.
Okay, good.
So what would you say is a classic high school movie from your generation that you think we would like, Suits?
God, I can't think of one movie that you guys would like.
He's always been 37.
Well, this is the thing. Yeah. I like your High School Musicals and the movies that you mentioned, I had heard of most of them, but I didn't see any of them. I had no interest in seeing any of those movies.
He hates people his age. Look how mature he is.
They weren't my kind of movies. I feel bad. I got like nothing here.
Oh, I am seeing this. What about Bring It On? What year was Bring It On?
I remember when that came out. I never saw that, though.
He would hate Bring It On.
Bring It On's a great teenage movie.
I saw the South Park making fun of it. That's about it.
Bring It On is way worse.
That's from 2000, dude. That's 23 years ago.
That's worse than High School Musical.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. All right. Maybe I should just edit myself out of this conversation.
Bring It Off.
Bring it off.
Yeah, even the High School Musical that you mentioned, 2006 on that.
Okay.
So, and I think my wife was telling me they're doing a High School Musical reunion and they're bringing back the original cast.
Oh, Zac Efron.
Yeah, that's why I was kind of surprised. I'm like, you're going to get Zac Efron back? But apparently Zac Efron, Vanessa Hudgens, what she's saying, Corbin Bleu, Ashley Tisdale.
Okay. I love Sharpay. Bring back Ashley Tisdale.
I don't want to brag, but I met her grandparents at McDonald's. True story.
Her grandparents are kind of braggers. They're just telling random dudes in McDonald's, our granddaughter's Ashley Tisdale.
We were doing a radio promotion. Nobody was there. I mean, Tumbleweeds was just crawling. And they walked up, our granddaughter is Ashley Tisdale. I'm like, well, that's awesome. Who's Ashley Tisdale?
Meanwhile, they were lying.
One text here says, there is no such movie called Bye Bye Baby with Steve Carell.
Damn.
You know what? I'm wrong a lot. Okay. I would like to do a KVJ retraction. It was Crazy Stupid Love with Steve Carell. I got it confused with another movie called Bye Bye Baby from 1989.
Okay.
That one's from 2011, Crazy Stupid Love.
And you know what? People are going to get me for going, Bert, it's not a complete high school movie.
It's about a husband and a wife.
But there's a big high school storyline.
What a turd. Look,
blame your boy. Kevin hired me.
Terrible suggestion, Kevin. I'm so sorry about my dizzy friend over here.
I don't agree with the word. It's an awful suggestion.
Bye-bye, baby. Bye-bye.
You should send me home.
Bye-bye. Time to go.
Go to Kevin's house and wake up Cannon for us.
I would like to give a shout-out to Karen from Broward. She is a new listener. She said, I recently started listening to you guys like a few weeks ago, and I'm obsessed. Oh. I love your radio station. I find myself tuning in every day, whether it's morning or evening. And if I miss parts of the day, I don't know whether I should feel old or not because I listen to a radio station. I'm 23, but what matters most is I find myself laughing with you guys and love turning you guys on when I drive from Davie to Boca.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know that drive real well.
Yeah, that's the worst of the traffic, girl.
Mm-hmm. So it's nice to have you along for the ride.
But I could give you the sweetest pizza map from Davie to Boca. I'm not even kidding you. The places you would have to hit from Davie to Boca.
Yeah.
I could, but we won't do that right now. It's not been a great hour for me.
Bye-bye, baby.
Also want to say hello to Dom. He is a new KVJ listener as well. He said, I found you guys one morning while scanning the channels.
Oh.
I'm so glad you're all so great together. I'm glad I found you. You got a new listener for life. Thanks for making my day better. So thank you, Dom.
And you're named after an awesome champagne.
Yep.
Okay.
Appreciate that. Coming up here in just a couple of minutes, we had a little bit more of a discussion about whether or not Jaybird should attempt emptying a bathtub with a teaspoon. That came up yesterday when we were talking about how much would it take for you to do it, and Bird's like, I'd do it for a bit. Like, okay.
Well,
how much time is he going to have to commit to this?
I need to chase greatness. It's just in my DNA.
So if we had a full bathtub, on average, they're 80 gallons. How long would it take to empty that using a teaspoon? I got the numbers breakdown for you next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
An accident on the Turnpike southbound is tying you up currently in Broward County. This one is at Griffin Road. Look for a right lane blocked in that area. Traffic a service of Palm Beach Mitsubishi. I'm Suits, 979 WRMF.
The brand new Palm Beach Mitsubishi is the local leader in customer service with the best selection of fully reconditioned pre-owned cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs. Palm Beach Mitsubishi, across from the Palm Beach Airport. PalmBeachMitsubishi.com.
Cue the dancers.
This is radio. No one can see the dancers.
Oh, but you gotta dance at Universal's Mardi Gras. The parade and music are back. The food and drinks are back. So great with a refreshing Coca-Cola Zero Sugar.
No one can see the dancers.
Great costumes, everyone.
We need to talk.
Florida residents get 2 days free with a two-park, two-day ticket and enjoy Universal's Mardi Gras, February 4th through April 16th. Tickets available at UniversalOrlando.com. Used by June 29th, 2023. Ticket prices vary by day. Restrictions apply.
We could fly to such great heights.
With MSC Cruises, a world of discovery awaits. Book now and cruise from $129, plus enjoy free onboard credit and more. Discover the Caribbean and the Bahamas, including Ocean Key, our private island marine reserve, Europe, and beyond. Only the sea offers you so much. Only MSC Cruises offers you so much more. To book, visit msccruises.com or call your travel advisor. Restrictions apply.
So, the other day, I bought an extremely chatty...
Boring story time!
Make that an extremely catty cockatoo.
You're welcome!
Apparently, the pet store won't take it back. But, hey, I'll manage.
I love that for you!
just like I manage without home internet.
No, you don't.
Sure, my mobile hotspot is slow and makes streaming shows unbearable.
Aw, Bertie likes to stream.
But I'm making do. Oh, no. Who's this?
My lady friend. It's mating season, duh.
No home internet? It's not that bad.
No, 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 not there.
It is that bad. Don't settle. Switch to Xfinity and get one line of unlimited mobile and home internet together for $50 a month for 12 months with no annual contract. Go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit your local Xfinity store today. Restrictions apply. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account. Equipment tax and fees extra. Reduced speeds after 20 gigabytes of data usage. Offer ends 3/21/23.
Hi there. I'm Mia. I'm Air.
You're Air?
Yeah. I just got out of the lungs of someone smoking a cheap little cigar outside a bodega. Oh, it was so smoky in there. And where there's smoke, there's
fire.
Cancer.
Oh.
Yeah. Little cigars might taste sweet, but they still kill. I'm supposed to be helping people, not unhelping them.
You mean hurting.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. I'm a bit of an airhead.
Little cigars are just as dangerous as regular cigarettes. Find out how to quit today at TobaccoFreeFlorida.com.
Hey, it's Suits and Publix's Greenwise Market is honoring one of the most flavorful days of the year. Join them for National Pizza Day all day on Thursday, February 9th. Celebrate with $10 cheese pizzas or $2 off other pizzas and pair it with a drink special. Plus, you can play bingo at 7 p.m. and you just might win a gift card. And new existing reward members enjoy an extra $2 off any pizza special purchased. Visit them at 8210 Glades Road. Drink specials vary by store. Drink responsibly. B21. Publix, where shopping is a pleasure.
Your health is about so much more than your medical needs, so shouldn't your health plan be too? If you qualify for Medicare and Medicaid, a Humana plan could give you $3,300 a year. That money can help pay for essentials like eligible groceries, rent, and utilities. It can go towards healthy foods, over-the-counter medicine, or costs like your cell phone or water bill. But Humana's dual-eligible special needs plans don't stop there. Pay nothing for your covered prescriptions all year long, even the name brand ones. You might even get free rides to appointments. Humana plans are designed for your whole life, for the big moments and every moment in between. Explore Medicare Advantage plans at humana.com/discover or by calling a licensed Humana sales agent at 888-654-0262. Humana, a more human way to healthcare. Sponsored by Humana Medical Plan Incorporated in the state of Florida, Agency for Healthcare Administration. Humana is a coordinated care plan with a Medicare contract and a contract with the Florida Medicaid program. Enrollment in any Humana plan depends on contract renewal. Allowance amounts cannot be combined with other benefit allowances. Limitations and restrictions may apply.
You know, as you get older, it is hard to stay in the same shape that you once were. Why is that exactly? It's your hormones. That's what's changing in your body. When you're in your teens and your early 20s, your hormones are raging. You notice you have more energy. You notice that it is easier to keep a better physique. Hormones. But as you get into your mid-20s, you start to lose them that early in life. You start to notice the effects in your 30s, your 40s, definitely by the time you get to 50 and approaching menopause. You don't have the same energy that you once did. You feel drained. You're having a hard time sleeping. You notice that maybe even your libido has changed. Well, you can turn all these things around by doing hormone replacement therapy at Wellington Anti-Aging. Notice immediately more energy. The testosterone for guys will help you maintain lean muscle, speed up your metabolism, and chase away fat. And for ladies, it can help you with hot flashes and night sweats and other problems with menopause. So get your free consultation today at WellingtonAntiAging.com. That's WellingtonAntiAging.com.
Experience the Anna Jaron Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
South Florida runs on Dunkin', and so does 97.9 WRMF.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
Trade in and trade up to a new Kia for less with one of the area's largest selections of new Kias available.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
Well, it seems like CPR has definitely been in the forefront ever since the Buffalo Bill player collapsed during the Monday Night Football game. And now we have another Buffalo Bill connection to how CPR saved another life. Maybe this is all of our signs to take a class. I'll share it with you coming up in your dirt.
Entertainment updates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
Yesterday, we were talking about how much would it take for you to empty a Roman-style bathtub with a teaspoon. Now, it's not painful or wouldn't be challenging, but it would take a long time. And so the question is, how much is your time worth?
Yeah, and I don't think I have a Roman style. I've got a regular bathtub, which I'm assuming we're going to be doing this at. But, I mean, at this point, a tub's a tub. It's going to take a long time.
Yeah, for the discussion yesterday when we started, we were talking Roman style bathtub. And so...
Are you going to do it in your guest bathroom?
Yes.
That's a deep tub.
That's deep.
Okay. It's not like a regular, like, little BS tub.
No.
It's actually very deep. It's not as wide as a Roman, but it's just as deep.
Yeah, I would say that would be the legit thing as far as for logistics of the camera and all that. Yeah.
So you can probably knock a little bit off these numbers then, because this is calculated for a Roman-style bathtub of 80 gallons.
I would say you probably have 60 gallons going on there, because his is deep.
She's terrible with numbers, but I like her passion, so I'm kind of torn right now.
I think it's
deeper. I really
And how do I know so much about your bathtub?
I don't know. She's in there pooping a lot.
In the bathtub?
In the bathroom.
Oh, okay.
You're kind of forced to look at it.
I was going
to
say.
I love to make doo-doo in his tub. It's my favorite.
So if you're looking at the time here, it would take 2.5 days or 58 and a half hours if you were doing 80 gallons, according to Nathaniel, who does our Do It B stats.
Is that different than the numbers you sent me yesterday?
Okay. And I kind of like Nathaniel's math because he really broke it down a lot more. And he went into very specific. He showed his math work.
If I did this at my tub, and we'll get all the dimensions so everyone knows what we're working with here, and we just kept the YouTube going, and I did not leave that bathroom until that last was gone.
Yeah.
Does that do well? Do people watch that, or heck no?
I think your back might give out before you get to the end.
Well, chasing greatness, you got to have a couple injuries. Yeah, that's of course.
Yeah, that is the biggest challenge. You're right.
I'm not worried about my back. I'm worried about how low the numbers will be. I think people tune in.
Well, maybe you could say that if we go under this many viewers, I quit.
That's a good point. I don't hate that either. There's an out. But that's not...
I will do it as long as I have 100 people continuously watching me. And the second I go under 100, I quit.
Does that take the spirit away from the challenge?
No, I think it's a dumb challenge anyway. So, I mean, you got to have a dumb out.
Layers of dumb.
Because otherwise you're talking, and this is 2.5 days if you're doing the 80. So let's say maybe it's 1.5 to 2 days because you're talking less than a Roman-style tub. This is not factoring in meals, fatigue, bathroom breaks, any other breaks, slowdowns, throwing your back out, all that kind of stuff is not factored into this 58 and a half hours. So you're realistically looking at it being 40 hours, a good day and a half to more.
And the other thing, you go, oh man, play some music, get you through it. But then if I'm doing it on YouTube, copyright issues.
Right. So I got to take you down for that. There's a lot of problems.
I got to go straight up silence, I think, or at least company. Maybe invite some people, my friends over, sit in the back.
Yeah.
You know, outside of the bathroom.
Right. Have a little smoke screen in there.
Are you kidding? And there's a lot of things you can do. Do we believe in this enough?
We believe in it.
Okay. I believe in this.
I'll have Denny's put up a KBJ TV poll. Should Jaybird a challenge or attempt to empty a bathtub with a teaspoon?
Will people watch that? That's the question.
Great question.
You're right. Yeah,
and will people watch, yes or no? We'll see where the numbers are on that and see what people think.
Well, you made a great point. Kind of like that giraffe giving birth. You don't watch the whole thing. You go in there, you make a sandwich, you check out, oh, bird's still working on the bath.
Yeah, it's weird what people will watch and what takes off. You would think that's never going to work, and then you're like, that worked?
Over, under.
Why?
You have to have 100 people watching at all times. If it dips over...
If it goes under 100, that's
done.
The out. So you have to tell people, okay, if you like watching this, go get a friend. Because if it goes below 100, I'm out.
You got to call people and tell them.
All right. Okay.
Stay on it. Don't give up on me.
I do like how you have a dumb out for a dumb bit.
Yeah, it's right there. Okay, so we got the poll going on right now in KBJ TV. Go to YouTube, and you can see it right there. People are voting. Would you watch Jaybird attempt to empty a bathtub with a teaspoon? We'll get the numbers for you coming up.
the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
It's the KVJ.
Dirt of the day.
Virginia, take it away.
Because you know we need that dirt of the day.
Well, this is awesome. My fun computer just went completely black. Denny's is here to try to assist.
Oh, no.
Oh, my
God. Do you
need
a stretch?
I think I can. I think I have the first story memorized, but beyond that, ugh,
okay.
So annoying.
Well, if you need any help, I got you whatever you need.
And I got you, too. I got some.
Just tell me what you want to do.
I got some wrestling news.
So we had heard the story about how Kim Pegula, who is the mother of the Pegula family that is the co-owner of the Buffalo Bills and the Buffalo Sabres, we heard that she was... You know, in the hospital and had been there for a while, but we didn't know what actually had happened. But now her daughter, Jessica Pegula, the number 4 ranked women's tennis player in the world, is talking about what exactly happened to her mom. I guess her mom was in bed when the dad awoke to his wife going into cardiac arrest.
Oh, wow.
And so the daughter like races in. She had just taken a CPR class recently. And she's like, I got this. And she starts doing CPR on her mom. They call 911. 911 comes, takes her mom to the hospital. And her mom is recuperating. And they say getting some of it back, but still dealing with significant issues. And the whole family pretty much says that it's because of Jessica, the daughter, and her knowing CPR.
It was Kelly. It was her other sister that did it.
Oh, Kelly. Okay, sorry.
That's all right.
So... anyway, sorry. The wrong sister I gave credit to, but she's the one that saved her mother. How cool is that?
It is really cool. Again, it does stress that, and it also just talks about, one, how scary and how serious this cardiac arrest can be because, you know, they say she's been dealing with significant expressive aphasia and memory issues, and that's where you just wonder with Damar Hamlin where he's going to be because when you have an interruption to blood flow, especially to the brain, these are the kind of problems that can happen. And unfortunately, you know, they don't know if she's ever going to return the mother to the way she was. And they said, we're just worried that she's not going to be able to be that person anymore with the many accomplishments and everything else that she was doing in her life. So
it sucks, but at least she's alive.
It is. Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, it's so much better than having to bury your mom at such a young age.
Absolutely. It's a good thing to know. And thank goodness somebody in that house knew how to apply CPR.
Well, we had said that there was a fight that happened backstage between Quavo and Offset at the Grammys. And then they came out and said, no fight happened. It's all good. We promise. But now, I guess video has surfaced and a fight did indeed happen. And Cardi B got in between Quavo and Offset to keep them from fighting about this whole tribute to Takeoff. So it absolutely did happen, and I can't wait to see the video.
Wow. Yeah, apparently she was yelling at both of them and saying they were both stupid and to blame.
I kind of agree. What kind of tribute is this to Takeoff if you guys are fighting and not being inclusive of each other and making drama?
Yeah.
And finally here, Post Malone has gotten very lean, and his dad has put it out there, okay, everybody, don't worry, he's not on drugs, he's not sick, he's just getting healthy physically and mentally, so you don't need to worry. If you see Post Malone and you're like, oh, he looks really like he's skinny and sick, it's not skinny and sick, it's skinny and healthy. So there you go.
Okay, good for him.
And that's what's going on in your dirt.
Okay, checking in with the YouTube numbers right now. Would you watch Jaybird attempt to empty a bathtub with a teaspoon? Right now, 54% say yes. 46% say no.
Aww.
Those are pretty low numbers. I don't know if it's worth it then. If people are that turned off by it, I say probably not then.
Yeah. Some people were saying, you know, hey, this could be a world record Wednesday attempt. Quickest time to empty a bathtub with a teaspoon that you could go for.
No, I want people to like the goofy challenges. I don't want them to be like, oh, it's lame. Oh, it's awful. I mean, 50%, half of them hate the idea.
Yeah,
oh, well. Yeah. Go back to the drawing board.
Mm-hmm. Did you tell us what you'd be wearing?
Oh, well.
Will you be in the tub? Will you be wet?
I mean, I'm so wet.
Those were all my ideas. I wanted you in the tub, in a Speedo. That's how you make it sexy.
That's true. You know, probably somebody is going to get bored this weekend and empty their bathtub with a teaspoon.
Well, good for them. Just know half of your friends will not like it.
Yep.
Send us a video.
Mm-hmm. Got a couple of celebrity birthdays today. Cecily Strong from SNL, or formerly, is 39 years old today. Vince Neil from Motley Crue is 62 years old somehow. John Grisham, the author, 68. Mary Steenburgen turned 70 years old today. She was an elf. A couple other movies that you love and cherish.
Oh, I love her.
She's great.
Great in Curb Your Enthusiasm.
She's so solid.
Step Brothers too, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Nick Nolte also is 82 years old today. Also got a happy birthday to Josh. You're the best dad and husband around. We love you. From Laura, Lily, Hayden, Rizzo the dog, and Meow Meow the cat. Got a 20th birthday to our man boy. Thanks for driving all the way down from Pensacola to share with your moms. We love you, Bubby, from Mom Biscuit, Jacoby, and Amelia. And you got a family photo there on KBJ TV.
Aw, cuties.
Got a birthday, want to shout out, send us an email, mail@kvjshow.com, mail@kvjshow.com. Coming up here in just a couple of minutes, we got 2 second tunes we're going to be ripping out here today. And we're doing a theme, it's for the Super Bowl. The halftime show on Sunday is going to be Rihanna, so is the artist in all of our 2 second tunes coming up next. The Super Bowl is going off on Sunday. Everybody getting all fired up for the Chiefs and also for the Eagles. Right now, the Eagles are a 1.5-point favorite. They say a lot of Americans are going to be gambling their faces off. More than 50 million American adults are going to be gambling on the game coming up on Sunday. 50 million.
That's a lot.
I'm gambling on the cheese.
Not the cheese.
The cheese. He's going to eat a bunch of Velveeta and hope to not poop himself.
They say that Americans are estimated to be putting about $16 billion down on the big game.
I'm gonna gamble a little bit in my community clubhouse. I'm going to go up there and drop a few bucks on a square.
Community clubhouse. Uh-huh. That sounds so
I'll be the youngest. Old, I'll be the youngest girl at this party by 20 years.
Good.
I'll take video.
Okay.
But they get down.
Should we get in on some action, Brady?
Yeah,
come on over.
No, I think we should put at least, I don't know, 20%.
All right, I like it.
20%?
20% of what?
We don't know yet. We're talking about that during commercial. But yeah, during commercial, we're going to figure out what 20% means.
That doesn't make any sense.
Well, they say that it's not just going to be straight football stuff. They got prop bets as well, where you can vote on things like the length of the national anthem. Is it going to be over 2 minutes and 5 seconds or under?
Who's singing it?
Who's going to get this year?
They got Chris Stapleton that is doing it.
It'll probably be quick.
I like him.
He'll get to the point, I think.
They say over is the safer bet at about 57%. Now, keep in mind, he's a little bluesy.
Yeah, blues likes to slow it down, girl.
So, yeah, they say right now over is the safer bet, especially when you consider the performer.
But how much money do you win if you go, all right, I'm going under? Do you win a lot of money?
Depends on how much you bet.
If me and Denny decide to put
20%.
20% down. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. 20% down. Yeah. What do we win?
You'll get probably 15% back.
Okay, baby. Yeah. Let's figure out what 20%.
All right, and then we'll figure out what 15% of that is.
I love it.
You can even bet on what color eyeshadow Rhiannon's going to wear.
Ooh.
See, those are the bets that we would probably excel at, right?
I'm going to go purple.
I'm going to go blue-green.
I was going to go blue. I was going to go greenish.
Yeah. See, me and Denny's are the new amigos.
Good. I like the underdog. I mean, I'm going to clean up with Rihanna eyeshadow.
They say right now, clear or none is the favorite at 71%.
No. Oh, wow. Kev, no. She's going blue or purple.
Huh? You can also do prop bets on who would make an appearance on stage with Rihanna.
All right.
Well, who do you think the odds-on favorite is right now?
Jay-Z.
Eminem.
Okay, Eminem is third. Jay-Z is first. Virginia, congratulations.
Thank you. I'll take my 20% now.
Okay, we just have to figure it out.
We can't figure it out. That's the problem.
They got Drake at 2, A$AP Rocky at 4, and Future at number 5. Kanye even drops in there at number 7.
There's no
I mean, that's how you win
way.
A lot of money. If you bet on Kanye and he shows up.
Plus 800 is the gambling odds on Kanye West appearing on stage at the Super Bowl halftime show with Rihanna.
We got to bet on it.
There's just no way. It's 20% of our money gone, Denny.
We got to find a bookie.
I think it's Jay-Z because he stands to make money.
Mm-hmm.
He's produced a lot of her music.
I think he's the one that discovered her, right?
Yeah, he's been there since the beginning. Yeah, and so he has a vested interest in her getting more streams. And if he becomes a part of the project, it'll get more streams.
Yep.
Yeah.
It'd be big.
Is it just as big if she brings out somebody that no one's expecting, like a Sheryl Crow? You go, what is this?
Depends on how they do it.
Okay.
Yeah, sometimes when you throw oddball artists together, it works.
I agree.
Depends upon how you mix it up. I mean, how crazy was it when they threw Run DMC and Aerosmith together back in the day?
You're right.
They said it couldn't happen, Denny.
What? Talking about what song she's going to be singing first in her halftime show, Don't Stop the Music, has the best odds at 25%.
Nope. Monster.
This Is What I Came For is second in odds. Diamonds, third. Stay, then Umbrella is down at number 5.
What's the one? There's a monster in my head. What's that one? What's that song called? That's the one she's opening.
Monster.
All right. That's a good guess.
Yeah.
Could be.
Disturbia is my favorite because it's all about a girl gone crazy.
Mm-hmm. It's not in the top 10. Really? On odds. Neither is Monster.
Oh, geez.
I think I'm saying the name wrong, maybe, but yeah, purple eyeshadow, and she's singing Monster in my head.
Okay. All right. Strong round.
20%.
Okay, so what we have is Rihanna songs here. You have to tell me in just about 2 seconds of the song what the title of it is. Virginia, Jaybird, Denny's going to be writing down their answers. Here's song one.
That's a tough one.
Yeah, that won't be number one. That's not going to be number one because that's got a guest collab on it. They're going
right.
to wait. They're not going to launch with that.
That's going to be the closer.
Mm-hmm.
Or in the middle.
Yeah, I think the middle. All right, Virginia, what'd you write down for the title of that song?
That's Umbrella Ella Ella.
Bird?
I'll just answer it, Umbrella. I want to sing it like her, but it's going to take forever.
Okay, yes. For the sake of time. And Danny, what did you write down?
Umbrella.
You got it. My umbrella. Okay. Everybody got a point on round one.
Okay. Nice.
It's a softball.
Okay. Okay. Rihanna, song number two. Okay. What is the title of this song? Uh-huh. All right. Big tune there. We're going to start off with The Bird. On this round, over there making weird monster noises.
Monster in my head noises.
Yeah. Jaber, what did you write down for the title of that song?
Feel me like a diamond. Feel me like a diamond.
Feel me like a diamond is the name of that song. Okay, Dennis, did you write that down?
I didn't. I wrote diamonds.
Diamonds. Okay. All right, you didn't write feel me like a diamond. Okay. Diamonds. Okay, Virginia, what did you write down for the title of that song?
Oh, I wrote down Diamond.
Diamond. Okay. But
I'm not confident. I'm having a brain fart.
It's man like a diamond.
I think that's the track.
Okay. Shine bright like a diamond.
Shine bright like a diamond.
Yeah. Oh, and you guys are all wrong anyway. It's not that song at all. Yeah, you're all completely whiffed on that. It's We Found Love.
We all thought it was diamond. We found love.
We really went all in on diamond.
We did. Well, she says diamond in the first words of that song. That's why. She tricked us. It's not on us.
Yeah, I agree with Virginia.
Okay. All right, song number three here. Rihanna songs you might hear at the Super Bowl halftime show. What's the title of this one? Okay. What is this? All right, one more time. Okay.
Oh, man.
Hear the chorus.
Denny's, what did you write down?
Only Girl in the World.
Okay. Virginia.
I didn't write anything. I'm having a brain fart. I'm so disappointed in myself.
Bird?
I wrote down the melody, what I heard in my head. Hot stepping in my face.
Hot stepping in my face? That is not correct. Denny's got it.
Oh! Oh! Like I'm the only girl in the world. Like I'm the only one that you'll ever love. Like I'm the only one who knows your heart. Only girl in the world.
Okay.
Damn, Denny's killing
that
it.
That one was so hard to think of, too. I had to shut everything out.
Doing great, kid.
All right, what do you think about this? Song number four, Rihanna tunes in 2 second tunes.
Okay.
Uh-huh, got it, huh? What is the title of this song? It might be a song to start the halftime show off with, possibly.
Yeah, that'd be a good one to start.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Virginia, what did you write down for the title of that?
I wrote S-O-S.
S-O-S. Bert, what did you write?
S-E-X.
No, it's not what you're looking for.
Mm-hmm. And Denny's, what did you write?
S-O-S.
Oh,
you. Is in the lead here.
Damn, Denny.
I'm a big Rihanna fan, you know.
You're killing it.
He's gotten 3 out of 4. Virginia's got a 2 spot. Bird is stuck at 1. Okay, here we go with song number 5 in 2 second tunes. What is the name of this song? Mm-hmm. It's a Rihanna tune.
Collab?
Yeah, I'll go with that. Mickey Echo?
That's who he's with?
Yeah, maybe.
Or is that the reverb they're using? I can't.
Mickey Echo.
Send it to Mickey Echo and start playing the piano.
We're not using reverb on this track.
Yeah. We're using Mickey Echo. Mm-hmm. Okay. One more time here. I need the title of this Rihanna song. Jaber, what did you write down?
Monster in parentheses in my head.
Monster in my head. Danny's, what did you write down?
I don't know if the title's correct, but something in the way you move.
Something in the way you move. Okay. I think you're on the right song.
At least
Virginia?
I wrote down Stay.
And you are correct. Oh, Stay.
Makes me feel like I can't live without you. It takes me all the way. I want you to stay.
Tie right now. Virginia and Denny's at 3.
Damn.
Arm wrestle.
Has the bird been mathematically eliminated, sir?
Yes, he was by the third song.
I'll go answer phone calls.
Bye, baby.
Let me just go figure out how to answer the phone.
Okay, here's your tiebreaker.
Oh, stay.
Like that song.
Sing it, Rihanna. I want you to stay.
Don't leave.
Okay, this is your tiebreaker between Virginia and Denny's. What is the title of this one? Very early Rihanna hit. What is the name of this? A little dance hall vibe there.
Can't tell if Virginia got it or not.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Denny's, we're going to start with you. What did you write down for the title of that song?
It sounded like the DuckTales intro.
DuckTales. Woo!
Okay. Virginia, what is the title of that song, For the Win?
I wrote down Ponda Replay.
Ponda Replay.
What the replay?
Does she open with that song?
It's old.
Yeah, I think it was her first hit.
Yeah.
Wow. There you go. Virginia comes back and wins 2 second tunes.
Wow. That's very fun. Yeah. Suck it.
Evil wins again.
Mm-hmm. Well, are you stressed right now? 5 minutes ago, you should have been. They say that the most stressful time of day is 7:23 a.m.
Really?
Is that when we play Do It, Bitch? Because that's when I'm most stressed.
No.
That's 8:23.
Yeah.
Is that, it has something to do with school and parents and rushing and getting to work and all that?
Yeah, I think it's just with everything that hits at about that time. It's being stuck in traffic. It's maybe you spill something on the carpet. You wake up late.
Yeah.
Oh, I saw it happen on Saturday. Sweet Dennis was driving, and he accidentally hit something and poured coffee on his ankle.
Well, so, you know when you're driving, I was holding the cup in between my legs while I was driving, right?
You got in an accident?
No, I stopped at a light that turned red abruptly, and my coffee just spilled all over my ankle.
Aww.
It shot off from, it was terrible.
And then he spilled it again on his leg?
Well, so later, I was drinking coffee, and I bumped my arm on a chair, and I spilled it all over my wrist.
You've been hanging out with the bird too much.
I had like a second degree burn on my ankle from
that
the coffee.
That spillerosis is contagious.
Yeah, right. Sounds like it. They say 33% of Americans are stressed every day. It seems low, doesn't it?
Yeah. They're lying.
They're lying, man. All right, coming up here in a couple of minutes, will Bird be stressed about the world record attempt he's about to put on? Fastest time to put on a t-shirt inverted. Now, last week he challenged Virginia and lost. So who's he going to be challenging this week? And will either one get close to the record? 3.1 seconds is the time to beat. We will find out coming up on the KVJ show.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
We're seeing some slowdowns currently on 95 southbound up on the Treasure Coast. An accident just beyond the exit for Becker Road causing those delays. Give yourself some extra time in that area. Traffic, a service of Palm Beach Mitsubishi. I'm Suits, 97.9 WRMF.
It's Valentine's Day every day in February at Palm Beach Mitsubishi. Feel the love with huge discounts off MSRP. Cha-ching! You make it to Palm Beach Mitsubishi and we'll make it happen. Palm Beach Mitsubishi. Across from the Palm Beach Airport. PalmBeachMitsubishi.com.
These days, $10 doesn't get you very far. But with Brightline, guests can ride to a shopping spree in Aventura or the new brunch spot in West Palm Beach everyone's talking about. Or to the next Miami Heat game. Brightline makes getting to everything South Florida has to offer easier than ever. Enhance your experience with in-station and onboard amenities like lounge access, crafted cocktails, and more. Book your next ride at GoBrightline.com.
Well, we just found out this is one of the most stressful times of the morning, and a lot of it has to do with getting out of the house and trying to get your commute. But how would you like to take away some of the stress of the day, especially when it comes to the commute? The Brightline can do that for you. Imagine just getting yourself to the station. You can even use Brightline Plus for that. And if you go on the app, check out all the deals they've got with Uber on there right now. That could get you to the station. And then once in the train itself, you can actually do your work right there while you use their free Wi-Fi and charge up your phone. Maybe get yourself a beverage in the morning to start off your day. You know, many people are doing this by getting the unlimited pass. It's $199 a month. You could save yourself half the cost of commuting between Miami and Fort Lauderdale. And so far, Brightline has taken 640,000 cars off the road and saved 1.3 million gallons of gas. It is the easy way to get around. So book your next car-free, carefree trip at GoBrightline.com or download the Brightline app today.
It's not easy being the one everyone counts on to keep your operation running, no matter the weather or supply chain hiccup. But we get you, Raymond in Buffalo, Maria in Miami, and Jules in Troy. Taking control of everything that's under your control. At Grainger, we're here for you with high-quality supplies for every industry, plus real-time product availability and access to experts ready to help. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Sounds like it's time to eat. And right now it's Seafood Fest at Bud's, which means homemade crab cakes and crispy coconut shrimp are back on the menu. So head to Bud's Chicken and Seafood. It's shrimply the best. Yum,
yum. In the next 30 seconds, one sweltering beach bum will decide
it's just too hot
and want to move somewhere milder. And as he's dreaming of cracking open a window, he'll realize,
I gotta sell my place before I can even buy a new place. And where am I gonna live in the meantime?
Or skip the hassles. Sell and buy in one move when you start with Open Door, so you can move on to the things that matter, like that cool breeze. Start with an all-cash offer at opendoor.com/newmove. Open Door is represented by Open Door Brokerage, Inc., license 02061130 in California, and Open Door Brokerage, LLC in its other markets.
You might not need a car today, but when you do need a car, go where I love to go now, where I love to send people, Classic Cars of Palm Beach. When you do need a car, don't you want to be treated right? Don't you want to get VIP customer service where they're not taking advantage of you or giving you the runaround or adding on fees or keeping you there at the dealership for hours and hours to wear you down? That's a sales tactic that the old traditional dealerships do. It shouldn't take 5 hours to buy a car. And at Classic Cars of Palm Beach, they want to get you in and out in under an hour. They want you to have a great experience. It's family owned and operated. John and Natalie run the show. Christian Rivera is the GM. Their kids all work there. It's a family-run business that cares about customer service. Go see the inventory and then see them in person on US 1 in the Jupiter to Cuesta area, classiccarsofpalmbeach.com.
Attention homeowners, it's Freeberry at ARS Rescue Router. Now is the perfect time to replace that old, inefficient HVAC system with a new energy-efficient heating and cooling system from ARS. For a limited time, you'll receive a free air handler with select new cooling systems, plus a free Nest thermostat. Call now or visit ARS.com for details, terms, and conditions. License number CMC 1249753, CAC 181-3963, CFC 142-8283, EC 1300-8558.
Call ARS and Rescue Router.
It's that time again, that time of year when dollar weed and clover invade southern lawns. This year, grab a bag of Scott's Turf Builder Bonus S and fight back. It's formulated for southern lawns so you'll get the nutrients your grass needs while also killing those pesky invaders. Scott's Turf Builder Bonus S. It's the number one brand in the South and has the 2-in-1 to start your season off right. Satisfaction guaranteed. Scott's, it's lawn season. Pick up a bag of Scott's Bonus S today at your local retailer.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Drive into love with hgregg.com on Military Trail. Whatever your taste or budget is, they've got a huge inventory of vehicles with a perfect match for you and your loved ones to make this Valentine's Day special. hgregg.com. Save more, drive happy.
Warmer Wednesday. Temperatures starting off in the upper 60s and low 70s. Mostly sunny and breezy and warm this afternoon. Highs topping out the low 80s. Tonight's lows in the upper 60s and low 70s. Tomorrow's highs, low 80s. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa for 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Extra Mile Cooling, Plumbing, and Electric. For all your cooling, plumbing, and electric needs, trust the five-star experts at Extra Mile. Visit ExtraMileFL.com to schedule your next repair. Extra Mile Cooling, Plumbing, and Electric. License number CFC 143773, CAC 1820657, EC 1301-1924.
Experience the Anna John Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
What's hot now on the KVJ Show?
It's going to be an awesome trip. I know Virginia loves Mardi Gras in New Orleans, but you're going to love Mardi Gras in Orlando. Universal has got a very cool deal going on as they celebrate everything Mardi Gras. In fact, they're bringing in the international flavors of Carnival from all around the world.
Ooh, sexy.
Yeah, it's going to be amazing food there, lots of family fun. There's going to be parades, concerts, all going on now through April 16th. And we've got tickets with Jeff a little bit later on this afternoon. You can listen to him, or you can also go to the WRMF mobile app, and you can win your Universal Orlando tickets to Mardi Gras there.
Get the info on everything that's going on with us at KVJShow.com.
World Record Wednesday, gotta give your best. World Record Wednesday, we're chasing greatness today.
All right, last week Jay Bird challenged Virginia to a world record, and she beat him. It was putting on the most underwear in 30 seconds, pairs of it. So today, Jay Bird is going to be going after the fastest time to put on a T-shirt inverted. So last week, it was the lower half. This week, it's going to be the upper half.
And I'm in the mood for a Denny's sandwich.
So wait, you're going to be upside down?
This is not an easy challenge, by the way. We both have terrible upper body strength.
Okay.
Lower body ain't so great either.
Some would argue it's worse. Okay. This is not easy, though.
When I saw this being done, this was a very nimble kid who had a T-shirt that was laying on the floor. It was kind of rolled out so you could see where the hand holes are for it. He started doing a handstand, walked backwards, put his feet on the wall, and then put both of his hands inside of the armholes of the shirt, and then lifted the shirt up over his head, and then when he got upright, it was on. He did that in 3.1 seconds.
My girlfriend that works out like she's training for American Ninja Warrior did this one time, and I tried to do it. I failed miserably. She barely did it, and she is in the gym like it's her job.
So is this your Braveheart speech for us, or...
this is guaranteed failure.
Okay. Guaranteed failure.
That's what you send Virginia in to bring people down before war.
I'm just keeping it real, 100.
No, she's not lying. This is going to be quite difficult, Kevin. We have to talk. We have to be honest about when do we throw the towel in?
Now.
Let's move on. No.
I'm just kidding. No, this would be a fun video.
Yeah,
I like falling video.
I think 30 seconds is fair. The kid did it in 3. So
wow.
You know, here we go at 30 seconds. I think it might just be painful after 30 seconds.
The kid did it in 3 seconds?
3.1, yeah.
And, okay, you know what? We talk about that guy who's got all of those world records weekly, David Rush. This is his kid's record.
Oh.
He's breeding them to...
Nepotism.
It's a family thing.
It's a family. Well, he earned it.
He's a Nepo baby.
Yeah, he did it. He got video. It's legit. So that's how the kid did it. But it was a kid that... Looks like he can walk on his hands and has good upper body strength.
Do you think we can do it? Not in a great time, but can we just get it done?
No.
Dennis,
I don't think so.
I mean, I'm with Kevin.
Yeah, the key's going to be that...
Just the inverted part's going to be a struggle.
Any pointers? I mean, we studied the tape. Mm-hmm.
Start smaller?
What I think you would do, you roll out the shirt, and then a lot of times they'll teach kids when you do a handstand, you wind up putting your feet up. I think it would just walk your feet up the wall, and then I would just try to get both of your hands inside the armholes of the shirt, and then take each arm and work it up over your body and your head, and then you just kind of fall, let your feet go to the ground, and then you pull the shirt down.
Lock your elbows. Don't let your elbows bend or you're done.
Can you get regular video, not for the, or just can you get raw video for us?
Don't tell me how to live my life.
Well, only because you're not going to, you're right.
I'm just kidding. I'll do whatever you want. You want it old people way, vertical or horizontal?
The new way, yeah.
Okay.
If not, yeah.
Okay. Well, I can maybe try to hold the camera up a little bit and work it as well.
Okay, so I love this. Okay.
Teamwork.
Yeah, we want to make sure the great people can see both of our fat pockets.
Fat pockets.
And a great
30 seconds we will put on the clock, and it'll be over if it's not accomplished in 30 seconds. Suits, do you think either one gets the shirt on? He's going with a no. Virginia, do you think either one gets the shirt on?
I don't think it's going to happen. I'm sorry, guys. But I love you.
Okay. All right, here we go. We're going to see Jaybird versus Denny's trying to put a T-shirt on. This is going to be inverted. They're laying the T-shirts out on the ground right now with the armholes exposed. Jaybird has...
I feel exposed.
Okay. You have sunglasses on. Could be a detriment to your task. Okay.
Anybody want to do a shot?
Yeah.
That was easy.
Mm-hmm. I'm so in.
Okay. Fellas are all ready here. Peace, unity, and a nice hug to start things off here.
Skin
Jaybird
on skin.
Versus Denny's. Okay, fellas, on your mark.
Oh boy.
Get set and go. They're in position.
Okay. All right. Okay, nobody's fallen yet.
Yeah.
Keep those elbows locked. Okay.
Camera's
Denny's
on.
Is close.
Okay.
Jaybird is getting it up. But
okay,
not
here we
on.
Go. Yeah, Jaybird has got one arm extended. He's putting his hand through it. You're halfway through.
Denny's got it.
Did it. Oh, very nice.
Denny's got it.
Actually did the work. Wow.
Oh.
Bird is down on the ground. And technically, Bird got it done as well.
Wow.
Under 30 seconds. How about that? Denny's looks like you did it in just about 20 seconds.
That was so hard.
How you feel, Cupcake?
That's amazing.
Oh, my God. That was rough.
Wow.
So I got snagged because the pressure, the weight of my arm on my shirt corner, I couldn't pull it up. But if I had gotten my hand in there cleanly, I feel like I could have got it up a little quicker.
That's really impressive. You guys did a lot better than I thought
wow.
you were going to do. Both of you did a really great job on it. Both of you under 30 seconds. Denny's did a little bit faster, so Denny's is going to get the head-to-head win.
And his is way smoother. Mine kind of, the ending was not good on my end.
Yeah, you went down hard on the ground.
But hey, give me some.
Denny's wow. was kind of graceful and everything.
He's great. The champion.
That was just unbelievable. I'm
so winded.
Gobsmacked.
I think World Record Wednesday got a new resurgence, my friend.
It is. Okay, so Denny's has got his first win. He goes to 1-0. Jaybird drops to 0-2.
And they both need to go lay.
Yeah.
No one ever said I was good.
Yeah. Didn't say you're good, but hey, you got it done. That is a win in my book. Very nice. All right, coming up here in just a couple of minutes on the KVJ show, it is Super Bowl week, and we're going to hear from Betty, who is telling everybody to keep it down for Super Bowl Sunday. She doesn't want any kind of noise. She wants to be able to focus on the big game. And, of course, it starts a fight. You're going to hear in some digital drama coming up next on the KVJ show.
Why do I feel like this? Can't even speak about it. I'm alive, I'm my head. Don't wanna think about it.
can't consume you. A disease of the mind, it can't control you. It's too close for comfort.
So we read the crazy crap they write and have a fun time. Well, get ready for this week's digital drama.
Got a Super Bowl fight coming up here in a second. We're going to start off with Tracy's post here. She goes to social media to complain about how her creepy neighbor is taking secret photos while she lays out.
Yeah.
Turns into a little bit of a fight here. I will play the role of Tracy. We will have Virginia playing the role of Linda. Bird can be Megan. And Megan. Denny's will be Andrew here in our post. Okay, so here we go. Starting off with Tracy.
I just found out that my next door neighbor has been secretly taking pictures of me while I lay out in my backyard. I am so creeped out right now.
OMG, that is awful. You need to report this predator immediately. Why are men the worst species in the world?
Like for real? I caught him looking over my fence with his camera. I'm not calling the cops. I'm having my boyfriend, Travis, handle it.
Okay.
Good. Travis needs to teach this creepster a lesson. Your neighborhood needs to feel the wrath.
of Travis.
Don't you have an OnlyFans page, Tracy? Don't people see you naked all the time?
Hold up. Preach, Andrew. Yeah, Tracy's showing off her body any chance she gets, and now she's surprised and butthurt that her neighbor is objectifying her body? Give me a break. You're attention-seeking, Tracy.
Yeah, it's not illegal to film somebody out in public. Tracy don't care that people see her naked body all the time on her OnlyFans page. But now it's an issue? Shaking my damn head.
She's just another thirsty wannabe model doing the devil's dirty work for him.
No, Linda, did you eat pain chips as a kid or something? You're like really stupid. Her neighbor is looking over her fence and taking pictures. That's not being thirsty. That's being a victim.
And by the way, y'all, I just talked to my boyfriend, Travis. Don't worry. Some street justice is about to be served, and I am so here for it.
Yeah, Travis.
Yeah, post was deleted about an hour later, so thank you for doing the screenshot on that.
They can just bring that into court.
Yeah, Travis, this is all the evidence they need to convict.
Yeah.
That's a whacked out news story right there.
Yeah.
All right, this post is all about the Super Bowl coming up on Sunday. Betty is telling everybody they need to keep it down. So exactly why is everybody fighting then? I will play the role of Sydney. Betty is going to be played by Bird. Virginia, you are going to be handling Trinity's role, and then we will have Denny's be Lou.
Lou! If you're going to have a Super Bowl party, please keep the noise down. I really don't want to call the police.
Or you could just mind your own damn business and stop being such a miserable Karen.
There's no need to be rude. I ask politely for you all to keep it quiet. Having a Super Bowl party doesn't give you the right to break all the rules. Last year, the nose almost gave my cats a heart attack.
Nose?
They have a heart condition.
Yeah, I thought the Super Bowl happened in January. When did they start playing in February? Man, I'm out of touch with sports.
The Super Bowl is this Sunday, and I have the cops on speed dial. Only halftime show y'all be seeing is the jail cell.
Ooh,
last year, someone ran over my plants, damn it. I'm not playing this year.
What's your problem, lady? Why do you have to be such a fart face? The cops don't care about your stupid complaints. I'm daring you to call them.
Don't worry, y'all. My boyfriend is a sheriff, and this Betty chick is off her rocker. We can get turnt and get crazy. My sheriff boyfriend told me we can do whatever we want.
Well, thank you, Trinity. I'm getting a bunch of kegs and chicken wings. Everybody in our block is invited except for that negative stick in the mud known as Betty.
Oh!
Let's go, Eagles!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hope you all have fun in jail.
Betty, you want everybody's fun. Thank you very much for all the posts. If you ever see anything entertaining that you'd like to hear us act out, just do a screenshot, because a lot of times they are deleted, and then you send it to mail, M-A-I-L, at kvjshow.com. Coming up here in a couple of minutes, we finally started playing around with that ChatGPT. That is the artificial intelligence that people are going in and using for all different things, from doing reports to writing letters to doing things for marketing. It's crazy all this thing does. You just type in a request and it does it for you. You could write out a movie script if you wanted to.
You know, you sent me a few things and I've got some notes about it. I've got some. One was really good that you sent me. Mm-hmm. One was really terrible that you sent me.
Okay. All right. So we got a couple things to check out here. In fact, we're going to put Jaybird up against ChatGPT. This is man versus machine, I believe. Are we still doing this?
Yeah, you'd sent it to me. Like I said, there's some issues with one, and then there's one that's kind of amazing.
Okay. All righty. So are we doing the...
I would say the fart sad song. See, the Bigfoot one, what it did was it took the verse and then it would take the chorus and mix the verse and chorus together.
Oh, really?
And then the second verse was the same verse. And
it was kind of a mess.
The fart one was...
You think it's better?
It was different. It was beautifully written out.
Okay. All right. Beautiful, huh?
Well, you'll see.
Okay.
Farts are beautiful.
So what does it sound like when you do a song on ChatGPT? We'll try it out coming up next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
We're seeing some slowdowns currently on 95 southbound up on the Treasure Coast. An accident just beyond the exit for Becker Road causing those delays. Give yourself some extra time in that area. Traffic a service of Palm Beach Mitsubishi. I'm Suits, 97.9 WRMF.
The brand new Palm Beach Mitsubishi is the local leader in customer service with the best selection of fully reconditioned pre-owned cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs. Palm Beach Mitsubishi, across from the Palm Beach Airport. PalmBeachMitsubishi.com.
Cue the dancers.
This is radio. No one can see the dancers.
Oh, but you gotta dance at Universal's Mardi Gras. The parade and music are back. The food and drinks are back. So great with a refreshing Coca-Cola Zero Sugar.
No one can see the dancers.
Great costumes, everyone.
We need to talk.
Florida residents get 2 days free with a two-park, two-day ticket and enjoy Universal's Mardi Gras, February 4th through April 16th. Tickets available at UniversalOrlando.com. Used by June 29th, 2023. Ticket prices vary by day. Restrictions apply.
What's better than one slice of pizza from Racetrack to get you going? How about two slices of pizza? And when you buy one slice, you can get any other for $1. Ayo, you can buy one slice of pepperoni for now and get the new bacon cheeseburger pizza for later for just $1. Or just get two slices for now. Buy one, get one for $1 slices. Get you going. Oh, I like that. We should put that on a t-shirt or something. Racetrack, whatever gets you going. Limited time item only at participating locations.
Of course I use Mr. Clean Magic Eraser to clean tough messes off my stovetop and bathtub. But then I discovered I can also use it to easily clean my patio furniture and even my shoes. I'm hooked!
And when wipes won't cut it, I use Magic Eraser Sheets. They're thin and flexible erasers perfect for everyday messes, like gunk on my counters and sinks. They really are magical.
The reviews are in. Mr. Clean Magic Eraser and Sheets make cleaning look easy.
When you want to get around South Florida the easy way to do it is to hop onto the Brightline. Cool thing about it, you can actually use Uber through Brightline to come pick you up at your house, take you to the station, and the station to your destination. Whether you're going to Miami, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, Boca Raton, Aventura, they got it all. And coming soon this year, service to Orlando. And to let you know how to do it, if you book 2 days before your ride, you could look into their flexible fares that go as low as $10. If you're going out with a bunch of friends, a group of 4 to 16, use the code ALLABOARD to get 25% off on their smart fares. And the thing I always find to be worth it is upgrading to premium so you can get complimentary drinks and snacks in the station lounge and also on the train as well. There's several different ways to book your trip. You can book it right now at GoBrightline.com. You can download the app as well. And that's where you can see all the deals you can get with Uber and everything else when you take the Brightline to your destination.
Close to 20 million Americans struggle with alcoholism. Our neighbors in Florida are no exception. Aware Recovery Care, a uniquely effective, pandemic-safe, Yale-inspired, in-home addiction rehab program is now serving Florida. What's more, it's duly accredited by the Joint Commission, the very highest standard in addiction care. If you or someone you love is struggling with alcoholism right now, call Aware Recovery Care at 844-AWARE-RC or visit AwareRecoveryCare.com. We're ready to help where and when you need us most.
Hi, this is Earl Ron. With New South Windows, you don't have to sacrifice energy efficiency for storm protection. Our products are Energy Star rated and made with impact and non-impact options, giving you the best of both worlds.
Buy more, save more. Volume discounts up to 30%. Visit NewSouthWindow.com.
You know, when I did my mommy makeover a few years ago, I trusted Dr. Rankin because I knew Dr. Rankin was going to do a great job. When it comes to anything, breast, body, lipo, mommy makeovers, Dr. Rankin is the pro I love and trust. He listens, he cares, and he has put together quite a team at the Aqua Plastic Surgery Center. This is what they do. They listen and they care. I know when I send people there, they're going to get great results and they're going to feel great about their procedure. Dr. Rankin, Dr. Deb, Dr. Bauermeister, and Crystal that does all the fun stuff, the Botox, the Kybella, everything. This team can help you. If anything physically is making you sad, go see them, talk to them, let them show you how they can get you feeling better, looking better, living better. Go to aquaplasticsurgery.com.
Determination comes in many forms, but always starts with a Dunkin' run. Grab your medium or large coffee in one hand. Grab a dollar donut in the other. No matter how you run, Dunkin' run. A dollar donut with any medium or larger coffee. Excludes specialty donuts and fancies. Price of participation may vary. Limited time offer. Terms apply.
I thought I was on my own when it came to filing taxes. But then Liberty Tax helped me overcome my taxiety. If you're suffering from moderate to severe taxiety, Liberty Tax might be right for you. If you've had taxiety for more than 4 hours, call immediately with your tax-related questions. Visit LibertyTax.com to book an appointment and overcome your taxiety with Liberty Tax. Taxiety is not a medical condition. See website for details. Terms and conditions apply.
I know it works because I've seen it work with my wife. Sometimes you get to that point in life where your body just has a slowing metabolism and there's really not a lot you can do with it. Maybe a hormone imbalance, and especially when you get close to menopause, it can be really hard to lose the weight. That's why Red Mountain Weight Loss was so key for my wife, getting her metabolism going and her hormones in balance. And it all starts with their RM3, an all-natural hormone that burns fat from your belly, hips, and thighs. You can lose 20 pounds by this time next month with the RM3 from Red Mountain Weight Loss. Imagine getting back to your ideal body weight. You can do it. And all the while eating real fresh food. You're not going to feel starved or deprived, and it's not a stimulant, so you're not going to feel nervous or jittery. Want to jump on it and see the same kind of success my wife did? You can schedule your online consultation by dialing #250 from your cell phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
It's Valentine's Day every day in February at Palm Beach Mitsubishi. Feel the love all month long with huge discounts off MSRP on any new Mitsubishi. Consistently voted top in customer satisfaction, we make it a priority to save you time and money so you can use those extra funds on that special someone. Cha-ching! You'll love all the amazing deals that are happening at Palm Beach Mitsubishi. You make it to Palm Beach Mitsubishi, and we'll make it happen. Palm Beach Mitsubishi, across from the Palm Beach Airport. PalmBeachMitsubishi.com.
Lytle, Ryder, Smith, Ivy, and Fronrath. Know your rights. ForYourRights.com.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio.
Trade in and trade up to a new Kia for less with one of the area's largest selections of new Kias available.
This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
Here's what's coming up on the Dirt of the Day. Dirt of the Day.
It's kind of hard to believe how many women have come forward to say that they hooked up with TJ Holmes while he was working at ABC TV and married.
Oh, boy.
But there's been another one.
Uh-oh.
I'll share the details with you. He is nasty. I will tell you everything he was doing because we have it coming up in your dirt.
Entertainment updates 5 minutes after every hour from the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
It's the classic tale of man versus machine. What will ChatGPT be good for, and what will it not be able to hold a candle to when it still comes to humans? It is kind of scary that you do have artificial intelligence out there that can write almost anything. We're talking about love letters, poems, songs, contracts people are using it for, term papers. In fact, it became such an issue with kids using it to write papers for school that now ChatGPT is trying to work with educators so they can start to see some of the telltale signs if somebody tried to write their report through ChatGPT. So it's pretty amazing stuff. And the one test I put it to was, I said, okay, could it write a love song about Bigfoot? And what do you know, Virginia? It just starts going and typing out a love song.
Oh, a love song to Bigfoot.
To Bigfoot, yeah. And I actually had the idea because remember years ago, Jay Bird penned out his My Sweet Sasquatch, which was a love song to Bigfoot?
Yes.
It's later because towards the end, we do make love.
Oh, okay.
Towards the end of this. You got to watch the video. It's layered.
Yeah, that's kind of a spoiler.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
Spoiler alert?
Yeah. Okay, so here's a little bit of Jay Bird doing My Sweet Sasquatch.
Bigfoot has a gentle soul, oh, and a spirit that you can't control. God's magic pumps through Bigfoot's bloody veins. Thank you, God, for making Bigfoot. I'm hearing Sasquatch screams. Because I'm having Sasquatch dreams. I wish I could stare in your Bigfoot eyes.
Okay, how about that, Virginia? My Sweet Sasquatch.
That is just pure lovemaking music.
That is.
It really is lovemaking music.
It is. So what I did was I submitted the words to Jaybird to see, okay, when you listen to the lyrics, because this is a competition of lyrics, not of playing in melody, Virginia.
Gotcha.
That was a studio version.
Okay.
What do you think? This is what ChatGPT wrote as a love song to Bigfoot. What do you think? Who did it better? Jaybird's pure passion, the man, or the machine, the ChatGPT? All right, Bird, let's hear a little bit of this love song.
She's rough.
Okay, yeah, just work it out. These are some of the
Bigfoot
lyrics.
Bigfoot likes it rough.
Yeah.
Wandering through the forest, I heard a rustling sound. My heart began to flutter, couldn't believe what I found. Then he stood, a legend, in the flesh, fur and grace. With the eyes that sparkled bright, I knew I found my place. Oh, Bigfoot, you're the one I've been searching for. With your gentle giant heart, I could love you evermore. From the fountains to the rivers, you roam wild and free. Oh, but you by my side makes me feel carefree.
Okay. Virginia, what do you think? That is what a computer draws up when you ask it for a Bigfoot love song.
I don't hate it. I thought it was a good performance.
It was a great performance, no doubt.
Well, you were telling us during commercial that you didn't love it. I loved it.
Well, only because I just got it, and I didn't have time to work on it, really.
Oh, I thought it was beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, verse two, Bigfoot. No.
I will have Suits put up a poll. We're going to find out, man versus machine, who did a better love song for Bigfoot? The man, Jaybird, as he wrote out his, or the ChatGPT, the machine, that wrote out a love song for Bigfoot? Now, this is the one that Jaybird thought might be a little bit better. You could even have it write a sad song about farts. So we just typed that into the ChatGPT and said, hey, could you give us a sad song about farts? And it actually dialed one up, which is pretty unreal.
So I haven't really worked on this one at all. Do you want to try to give a little melody to yourself?
Oh, I'll try to jump in here. Yeah.
Tell me if the melody hits you.
Okay. Yeah, that's heartfelt. That's heartfelt. Yeah, fart felt. In silence, they sneak away. The farts, they steal my breath each and every day. Memories of laughter are now long gone. Brings a tear to my eye, but they carry on. Oh, my sadness, it's all I know. With farts, it's a constant show of sorrow and pain. They never cease in the sadness. I find no peace. They linger in the air and they won't depart. These farts, they pierce right through my heart.
That's not any practice ever.
That's just trying to figure it out using the lyrics of ChatGPT.
That's just raw, baby.
Do you want to try it?
Did you think that it wrote out a beautiful, sad song about farts, Virginia?
Yeah.
Are you impressed with what this computer's doing? Or do you feel like, I don't know.
I've been moved by everything you've done.
I mean, moved. Did you mean like bowel movement?
No, I liked it all.
I think Kevin kept on. He's a very emotional singer.
I thought he was about
to say something.
I was throwing him a lot of rhythmic curveballs over here. I did. That wasn't easy.
I mean, anything else? You want to try any more?
I think it's going to be interesting just to see what people see. In fact, I was thinking about doing something for Valentine's Day coming up on Tuesday. We're going to give you the chance, if you want, we're going to be doing some of the love poems from the ChatGPT. Because they will write those up as well. And I don't know what you think about some of them, but I typed in one for the Mexican Queen. And amazingly, it wrote up a love poem for my wife.
That's awesome.
Yeah, just boom, like nothing in it. I'm not a judge of poetry, so I can't really say, but I didn't think it was that bad.
Didn't you kind of have a poetry run when you were like 17?
I did, and it was terrible.
But, I mean, this is like plenty that you could put in a Valentine's card.
Yeah.
And maybe even just a few lines from a big poem that the thing writes for you.
But I heard a very interesting conversation. They go, it's going to get to the point where they go, that you say something like, send a nice message to Kevin. And it's going to just automatically send a nice message to Kevin that I really didn't write, but it's going to appear that I wrote it. I don't know if I like that.
This is what we're dealing with. The possible insincerity of society. All I said was, will you write a love poem for the Mexican queen? I said this to ChatGPT. What do you think about this? If you got this, Virginia, here is the poem that ChatGPT wrote.
Okay, I'm going to put myself in the mind of your wife, Kim, the Mexican queen.
Okay, let me see what we got here.
Will she like this?
Do you need peaceful music?
I think I might have something over here.
You better make it good, because she is not a fan of stupid. She don't have a lot of tolerance for that. It better be good.
Oh, Mexican queen, your beauty shines so bright, like a sun-kissed desert where day turns into night. With eyes as warm as cocoa and hair as black as coal, you're a goddess among women who steals my heart's control. Your grace and strength, an inspiration to all, with a spirit as fierce as the cactus standing tall. Your smile is sweet as agave, your laughter a symphony. In your presence, I feel alive, and my soul sets free. I mean, what do you think of that?
I mean, that's passion.
Look, it's hot. It's heat.
It's not bad, and I can completely cheat, and I will, because I'm a cheater, and I'm going to send this to the Mexican queen for Valentine's Day on Tuesday.
I just saw Puss in Boots in the theater over the weekend with Rocco. This totally sounds like something Puss in Boots would say.
Right.
And he is sexy.
Right. That's what it wrote up.
I love it.
Well, just to let you know, when it comes to love songs for Bigfoot, we did a poll in the KBJ TV chat room, and right now, the man still wins.
Okay.
Bird, yep.
Okay.
72% of the vote, the man over the machine.
So thank
God.
If
you want a love song for Bigfoot, still go to the man that has all the passion.
It's the KVJ Dirt of the Day. It's the KVJ Dirt of the Day. Virginia, take it away. Because you know we need that Dirt of the Day.
Well, a fourth accuser that worked at ABC Television with TJ Holmes has now come forward to say, okay, you guys should know he did it to me too. The woman who has been identified as Sasha, which is such a hot name, Sasha, says that TJ basically treated her like a throwaway object. She says, look, this is just the culture. This is what they would do. Good Morning America execs would prey on young female colleagues. And these female colleagues were there working long hours. They felt pressure to have affairs with the senior members of the team. And we're told this is just what happens. She revealed that her affair with TJ began when she was 27. The year was 2014, and they were working overnights together on ABC. Now, it should be noted, because I looked it up, he got married in 2010. So he was very much married in 2014 when he began hooking up with this 27-year-old colleague that was definitely under him on the totem pole and the bedroom.
That's your problem.
Yep, that's your problem.
That's the problem.
You can't do that to underlings, and especially if it's like a culture that everybody participated in and knew about. And
that's
like,
no one's going to let that fly.
There's probably so many more Sashas that have the same story, but maybe don't want to come forward and ruin their lives with it, but you can't do this. So I think ABC did a good job of not having TJ come back.
Mm-hmm.
But I think he got a huge payday to walk away. So
the dude's kind of winning, actually.
It's reinforcing bad behavior, and he will get more gigs. He probably has a podcast already.
Yeah, I'll tell you, podcasts don't really pay that
great. Podcasts do not pay that great.
In my experience, I've lost money on a podcast.
Yeah.
Continuously.
LeBron James had a big night last night. Did you see? He is now the NBA's official all-time leading scorer, surpassing the record that was set by Kareem Abdul-Jabbar for the most points logged in league history.
This is a big deal, by the way.
This is a very, very big deal. Yeah, especially, you know, you always have that ongoing, who's the GOAT? Is it going to be LeBron? Is it going to be Michael Jordan or Kobe?
It was kind of cool because it happened last night and Kareem was there.
That's awesome, yeah.
The one who set the record, and he was, of course, congratulating LeBron, and that's just a cool emotional moment.
Mm-hmm.
Looking for James. He's got it. LeBron James has shot at history.
Uh-huh.
And he ain't done.
No,
it looks like he's slowing down a bit.
No, he's still playing at a very high level.
To me, sports needs that stuff. You need those kind of milestones. You need those storylines.
Mm-hmm.
And finally here, talking about sports storylines, I know you'll like this one, Jay Bird. Well, you'll be sad, but you'll be happy that it's included. WWE legend Jerry the King Lawler had to be rushed to the hospital. They say he had a medical emergency, and they believe it was a stroke. He underwent surgery. He's right here in Florida, and his friends are hoping he's going to be okay. But, yeah, they're asking for prayers and genuine good vibes. Send them the way of Jerry the King Lawler.
One of my all-time favorite announcers. And if you remember the movie Man in the Moon with Andy Kaufman and all that, he's the one that had the battle with Andy Kaufman that slapped him and did all that stuff. Mm. It's the king.
Okay. And that's what's going on in your dirt.
You don't know what I'm talking about.
I'm just saying I do, but I don't.
I can tell.
No clue. Yeah. No.
Yeah, I can feel the whole energy leave.
I don't want to leave you hanging, but
she did just kind of completely leave you hanging.
Sorry to you and Jerry.
It's okay. Mm-hmm.
It's time for viral audio.
So had your kids, had your wife.
Double rainbow all the way across the sky.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
So what do you think about going into a dark room for 4 days? It's called a darkness isolation retreat. And Aaron Rodgers, the quarterback of the Green Bay Packers, says this is what he's going to do when contemplating his future and where he's going to go or whether he's going to go play football somewhere else.
Huh? It's 4 nights of complete darkness. It's a darkness retreat. I've had, you know, a number of friends who've done it and had some profound experiences. And it's something that's been on my radar for a few years now, and I felt like it'd be awesome to do regardless of where I was leaning. It's coming up in a couple weeks. It's a room. It's a little house. There's a two-way, like a little slot that they'll drop in some food for you. No music, no nothing. Just myself.
Wow. Does that sound like that is a good idea? Or?
It sounds like he's got too much money. Because you can do this at home in your closet. And it's going to be a lot cheaper than going to a retreat. And I'm sure paying them thousands.
Yeah. He's got his own little place. I don't know if he's going someplace or he's going to be at his own
place. Instead of the retreat. A darkness retreat.
A retreat.
Yeah.
You have to say it like that. A retreat.
This is just how you know you have too much money.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Go in your closet and shut the door, bruh.
Yeah. So there you go. I guess we'll find out. Kind of like with the groundhog when he emerges from his hole.
Will Aaron Rodgers see his shadow?
That's a great question. It's what we're all going to be waiting for. It's going to be very exciting. All right, I want to do a real quick shout-out to Vera. She's turning 11, having her birthday. She's one of the biggest KBJ nationers. Thank you very much, Vera. Woo-hoo! Have a happy birthday.
Vera!
Also, coming up here in just a couple of minutes, we're getting to it, your makeup or breakup emails. Are we going to be ending some relationships here today? Somebody wants to know, this is a violation of the term being exclusive, right? And I shouldn't allow this. What exactly does he want to do? We will find out coming up next.
God, I wish somebody would have told me when I was younger. All bodies aren't the same. Photoshop, bitty bitty models on magazine covers. Told me I was overweight. I stopped eating. What a bummer. Can't have carbs in a hot girl summer. I could go back and tell myself when I was younger, I'd say, psst. I know Victoria's Secret.
they're made for me and you.
Okay, we got some makeup or breakup emails here. If you want to jump in on this, Virginia, you can join me here in a few of these. I know we got this one right here is somebody wanting to know. This is a violation of being exclusive, right? What do you think on this? The email says, I've been dating a guy for just over 2 months, and we decided that we'd like to give a relationship a shot and not let going out with anyone else ruin what we might have. We have hung out every single Friday night since we met, but he tells me that he can't hang out this Friday because he has to escort one of his friends to a fancy charity gala that she has. He says that she uses him as her plus one because it's just easier knowing that they're only friends and there won't be any weird romantic entanglements. I know he said this last part for my benefit, so I wouldn't be jealous or feel threatened, but it didn't work. I don't care if there's nothing romantic and he has zero attraction to her. Being a convenient on-call date goes out the window once you are in an exclusive relationship, right? I didn't make an issue about it, but I am pissed. Do I stay silent, say something, or move on? This bother you? Is this a violation of what is called being exclusive?
I think it is. Because if you're going to an event with this girl and you've always gone to events with this girl as a plus one, it's insinuating to everybody in the room that you guys are a couple. And now that he's exclusive with you, he can't play that fun little acting role anymore.
Mm-hmm.
It's not cool.
I think so, too. I think if you agree on the terms that we are exclusive, that you want to stay away from things that send messages that you might be in a relationship with somebody else. And I know people can get all bent out of shape, but you know, Ashton Kutcher, in fact, just did something which I think is admirable and probably something that a lot of people should mirror. He just took some photos with Reese Witherspoon at their Netflix premiere, and people are like, that's awkward. Even his wife said those photos are awkward, just the way you're standing there.
He's scared to touch her.
I understand it, though. I get
it's
it.
It's real. Yeah. It's real.
And he said he wanted to avoid any affair rumors. Now, not everybody's going to be judged the same way Ashton Kutcher is, but I can tell you just how you live in your society and people know you, they will watch your body mannerisms and people will talk. Here's what Ashton Kutcher said as to why those photos came off so awkward.
If I put my arm around her and was like all friendly with her, like that would the rumor right. would be that I'm having an affair with her.
Right.
If I stand next to her, I put my hands in my pockets, so there's no chance that like that could be the yeah. rumor. The rumor is we don't like each
yeah,
other.
Yeah, you guys hate each other. Yeah.
Reese and I are really good friends. We're really close. I don't have to defend that.
So if you are in a committed relationship with somebody, you wouldn't want to do anything where somebody might talk and think that you're in a relationship with somebody else.
I was raised very old school. My mom was just, if my dad would be in a picture with somebody, he'd be the same way. You want no kind of weird thing to be able to be called out on. I get that only because I was raised by old school parents. If you're in a relationship and a deep relationship, you do everything to protect that and not to make it look like there's other stuff going on.
So she asks, do I stay silent, say something, or move on? I would say something.
Yes.
And I think that's it. I don't know about moving on, but I think you need to say, hey, look, if you want this thing to be exclusive, here are some terms. And you're always okay. That's what a relationship is about. It's about finding out people's boundaries and then deciding whether or not you can live inside of those boundaries or not. And you're well within your right to say, being in an exclusive relationship with me means you don't escort other women to formal functions.
Yeah. Okay. And if you can't do that, then we can't be exclusive.
Right. Why be exclusive? That's not being exclusive necessarily.
Right.
You only got one life. Say what you got to say.
Yeah. Virginia, why don't you take the email to make up or break up? Should this kill a second date?
Okay, this one from this girl says, I went on a date with this cute guy the other day. We went to a place where you order at the counter and then they bring your food to your seat. Well, he got his food first and started eating right away. He didn't ask me if it was okay. He just dove right in. I could see if the food was warm, but we're just talking sandwiches with a side of chips. He was on his last few bites when my sandwich finally arrived. We sat until I was finished, and then we left. I was talking to my girlfriends about this, and they thought it was a sign that this guy should be just a one and done. He's cute and nice and everything, but I was going to give him a second date. Should I?
Okay. This is a big deal. Jaybird, if you were on a date and she's digging right into her sub, yours hasn't gotten there yet, and by the time you get yours, she's pretty much done with hers. Does that bother you at all?
Only way it would bother me is if already the date was going bad and she was annoying me. If I like the person, that's something I can, without a doubt, get over. I understand why people would be annoyed. And yes, technically, you should probably wait for the person so we all can eat together. But am I going to be butthurt and get all upset about it? No, life is too short. There are things to get mad about.
Right.
Now, if she's done other things and that's the last thing you see her do, that's a different story.
Okay.
But if we're crushing on the date and we're having a good time, I'm trying not to let those kind of things bother me.
Yeah.
The older I get.
Yeah, and as you realize, especially as you get older and it starts thinning out and you're realizing there's a lot of toads out there, you may not, you know, judge too harshly on somebody that delves right into their delicious sandwich.
Maybe she's hungry. Maybe she came from a childhood where there was only one sandwich and they all had to jump out and get the sandwich at one time. I don't know. It's a first date.
Yeah. And one more make up or break up email here. This is a tough one because it says in this email, I'm getting married in 2 months, but now I'm wondering who I'm about to marry. During a game of Never Have I Ever with friends, the question came up, never have I ever robbed a guy like Cardi B. My girlfriend drank and her friends laughed and then high-fived her. So after we got home, I'm kind of like, hey, what was that question all about? And she admitted that when she was in her early 20s in Fort Lauderdale, she actually drugged and robbed a few guys who came onto her at a few bars. She said they were complete creeps who deserved it anyway, and she thinks she's like some kind of Robin Hood or something. It was 10 years ago, so it appears to have cleared her conscience because she doesn't seem busted up about it. But now I'm just wondering who I'm with. I never pegged my fiance as the kind of person who would do this kind of thing. And now I'm actually kind of horrified at what I'm about to marry. Do I need to rethink this?
Drugging people? She definitely drugged people? That's what's going on here?
She
drugged and robbed.
She did. Drugged and robbed. These guys came on to her. She was out with the girlfriends in bars in Fort Lauderdale. These creepy dudes, they, you know, and maybe they came on way too strong. They wouldn't leave her alone. She's like, okay, whatever. Yeah, let's go back to your place. So she has something. She puts it in his drink. He passes out. She takes a couple Rolexes or his wallet and calls it good.
Here's the problem with that story, because this is what criminals do. When they all the investigations, they sit him in the room. They try to do as much as they can to look as human and as great as possible.
Yeah.
They were creepy dudes and they blah, blah, blah. And they did this to me to kind of set the stage of they're creepy, they deserve it. If you're drugging people and robbing them, I can't believe anything you're saying. That means the beginning part of your story, when they were creepy and painting somebody in a terrible light. You robbed people, you drugged people. I believe nothing what you say other than the bad stuff.
The attitude on how they handle it now and what lets me know that this probably is something that her whole friend group did. Why did they all laugh and high-five her?
They all knew.
Because they don't feel bad about it.
Or they may have done the same thing. That might have been what her friend group did when they're in their 20s bar hopping in Lauderdale, is drugging and robbing guys.
I mean, you can accidentally kill somebody that
way.
That is scary.
Yeah, that's a tough thing to let go of. That's a massive issue where your attitude towards you having done that needs to be one of complete remorse. And that I can't believe I did this. I feel so bad about who I was. I'm so glad I've changed.
That's different.
This doesn't sound like that.
No, not because they're high-fiving.
High-fiving and laughing. And that question almost sounds like it's set up.
Well, she's also, anytime she gives me a drink or we're hanging out, and I feel a little woozy.
Right.
Like, is she Cardi B in my head?
What's going on?
Yeah, I think that's a breakup, right?
Oh my gosh! Yeah, because they don't. She doesn't care.
Yeah.
Uh huh.
I agree. Yeah, you got to be concerned about your fiance's character with that one. All right. Do you want to admit that you used to drug and rob guys? That's just what this is all about. It's pretty much a judgment-free zone, but we might make some comments to your confessions.
Don't speak for me. I'm very judgmental.
Yeah, he's going to be very judgmental. You can text him into us, though, and remain anonymous so your name doesn't get blasted. Send it to us right now, 877-979-WRMF. We got your confessions next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
At the moment, you're moving slowly through Delray Beach on 95 southbound. We have a crash beyond Atlantic Avenue that's blocking two right lanes. Give yourself plenty of extra time through that area. Traffic a service of Palm Beach Mitsubishi. I'm Suits, 979-WRMF.
It's Valentine's Day every day in February at Palm Beach Mitsubishi. Feel the love with huge discounts off MSRP. Cha-ching! You make it to Palm Beach Mitsubishi and we'll make it happen. Palm Beach Mitsubishi, across from the Palm Beach Airport. PalmBeachMitsubishi.com.
Every small business owner knows business happens everywhere. The office, the warehouse, or on the road. And no matter where it takes you, there's one solution to help your business thrive. Comcast Business Complete Connectivity. It's the largest, fastest, reliable network with advanced gig speed Wi-Fi and cyber threat protection in one solution. Plus, add Comcast Business Mobile and you can save up to 60% a year on your wireless bill. Get started for just $40 a month for 12 months with no annual contract when you add mobile. And ask how to get up to a $750 prepaid card.
Flight 291 is now boarding.
Yep, you're going places. And when you get there, be ready to do business. The Complete Connectivity Solution from the company that powers more small businesses than any other provider. Comcast Business, powering possibilities.
Ends 2/21/2023. Restrictions apply. Requires EcoBill and AutoPay. New 100 megabits per second internet and Comcast Business Security Edge customers only. Equipment taxes and fees extra. After 12 months, regular rates apply. Gig internet required for gig Wi-Fi. Mobile savings compares pricing of top three carriers.
I had had it with squinting. People kept getting on me. So my eye doctor even said to me, he's like, you know, Kev, you're going to need glasses like now or contacts. And I said, I don't like either. I've had both. And he said, well, you can try a LASIK procedure, but, you know, you want to ask around. So I did. Started saying, hey, where would you go? And people kept saying Panu Laser. And so I asked them why. And they said, well, I mean, one, they're convenient. And when they did the research themselves, they have really good customer reviews. So I went in for a consultation. After talking to Dr. Moutiel, I felt really good about it. First of all, nice, clean offices. It looks like a day spa. They also have state-of-the-art lasers. That made me feel comfortable. And then to know that Dr. Moutiel has performed over 50,000 LASIK procedures put me at ease. They even told me, he said, look, the procedure's so easy. A laser does all the work, and it's going to take 90 seconds in total. He was right. And you know what? The recovery time is nothing, and I was back to work the very next day. One of the easiest things you'll do. So where do you go? Panu Laser. Find them online, panulaser.com. That's P-A-N-N-U laser.com.
It's that time again, that time of year when dollarweed and clover invade southern lawns. This year, grab a bag of Scott's Turf Builder Bonus S and fight back. It's formulated for southern lawns, so you'll get the nutrients your grass needs while also killing those pesky invaders. Scott's Turf Builder Bonus S. It's the number one brand in the South and has the 2-in-1 to start your season off right. Satisfaction guaranteed. Scott's, it's lawn season. Pick up a bag of Scott's Bonus S today at your local retailer.
Stringer's Tavern and Oyster Bar isn't just beautiful to look at. Their new menu has kicked things up a notch, and they're excited to show you just what beautiful tastes like. They have new dinner and lunch entrees to love and a daily happy hour that keeps everybody coming back for more. And get this, Buck a Shuck is now available during happy hour from 3 to 6 p.m. and all day on Sunday. Speaking of Sunday, Sunday brunch has begun. Having a party? Let them host. For more information regarding weekly events, parties, reservations, and the music lineup, visit stringerstavern.com.
Hi, I'm attorney Robert Rubenstein with another edition of Rubenstein's Rules for Personal Injury. Rule number 3, insurance companies are not your friends. They are not your good neighbors, and you are definitely not in good hands. Insurance companies fight every day to not pay claims. They don't want you to get a lawyer, but they have lawyers. So what should you do? Hire someone who is really on your side, right now. Call Rubenstein Law at 1-800-FL-LEGAL. offices in Palm Beach and throughout Florida.
Everybody in my neighborhood loves cooling advisors. The word spread. My one neighbor used them first, then the other neighbor, and now everybody's telling everybody, cooling advisors, family owned and operated. They do it right the first time. It doesn't matter if you need just a simple tune-up or a complete overhaul like my one neighbor did. She switched out her whole system and all her ducts, and cooling advisors did it so well for her. She loves her new system. I love mine too. They put mine in 2 years ago and I can control my thermostat from my smartphone. It is so cool. Cooling Advisors, over 70 years of AC experience. They're family owned and operated, and they've got a live person answering the phone 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So whenever you need them and you call them, they jump into action. Go online today and get the company I trust, coolingadvisors.com.
South Florida weather is 15 seconds away from the H. Gregg West Palm Beach Weather Center.
Drive into love with hgregg.com on Military Trail. Whatever your taste or budget is, they've got a huge inventory of vehicles with a perfect match for you and your loved ones to make this Valentine's Day special. hgregg.com. Save more, drive happy.
Warmer Wednesday. Temperatures starting off in the upper 60s and low 70s. Mostly sunny and breezy and warm this afternoon. Highs topping out the low 80s. Tonight's lows in the upper 60s and low 70s. Tomorrow's highs, low 80s. I'm WPTV First Alert meteorologist Jennifer Correa for 97.9 WRMF.
This report is sponsored by Extra Mile Cooling, Plumbing, and Electric. For all your cooling, plumbing, and electric needs, trust the five-star experts at Extra Mile. Visit ExtraMileFL.com to schedule your next repair. Extra Mile Cooling, Plumbing, and Electric. License number CFC 143773, CAC 1820657, EC 1301-1924.
Experience the Anajar and Levine difference. Call 1-800-747-FREE.
What's hot now on the KVJ Show?
You know, if you download the WRMF app, we got a lot of great stuff waiting there for you. We're live right now, streaming on the WRMF app. You can also pick up our regular show and after the show there on demand anytime you want. Plus, just by listening, you can pick up tickets to Sam Smith, Madonna. We got cash, trips, all kinds of good stuff. Or you can send us text and audio messages all through the WRMF app. Just go to your app store and download it for free right now.
Get the info on everything that's going on with us at kvjshow.com.
Okay, got your confessions rolling in here. 877-979-WRMF. 877-979-9763. I don't know if this person is being legit or not, but one person just let us know as a follow-up to that makeup or breakup that we had a couple of minutes ago, where this girl actually confessed in a game of Never Have I Ever that in her 20s in Fort Lauderdale, she would... drug creepy guys and take their stuff.
That's scary.
Somebody said, I went to a bar in Fort Lauderdale 10 years ago. Oddly enough, I woke up the next morning naked in a random backyard. My wallet was missing when I woke up, and I had to walk 2 miles home using just a towel I found.
Well, it's easy to call someone creepy when you're robbing and drugging them. It makes you look less of a monster. It just does. It happens all the time.
Yeah. So hopefully that guy leaves that girl. And interesting to see exactly who her victims were and how they feel about that, even though it was 10 years ago. Got some other interesting confessions. What kind of things are people doing out there in the world? It's a fascinating little look. With your text, you can remain anonymous, sending it to us, 877-979-WRMF. One confession says, I told my girlfriend I have stomach ulcers and Crohn's disease, so I can say I'm not hungry and just don't feel well, but in reality, I can't stand her cooking.
Dude, that's a lot of work. Now you got a fake Crohn's?
Yes.
And don't you think if you work hard enough, you cannot be a sucky cook?
You gotta switch it up. Okay, after she gives you a meal that you don't like, you need to give her helpful critiques. Uh-huh. Don't tell her it's terrible. Maybe just say, okay, maybe a little less salt, or maybe a little more like, you don't have to fake Crohn's.
You know what I've learned? It's all about what people are passionate about, and that's true and near and dear to their heart. I'm just now getting in that cooking world, and I want to ask, hey, Virginia, did that taste good? Was it bad? Because I'm learning. Mm. But someone like my mom, who loved to cook,
yeah,
she took such pride in it. She would take offense if you didn't like it. Because she had such pride. She was too in it, if that makes sense.
I get it. And if you have that attitude, it might be tough to critique somebody to help them get better.
You can't critique somebody that's going to yell at you.
Yeah, it's true. And are there some people, like, there's some people that just can't take care of plants. They kill them all the time. Are there just some people that can't learn to cook?
There's a trick on TikTok that these ladies are doing to their men, and it's pretty funny. So they take a spoon, and they put salt in the spoon, and then they dip the spoon into whatever chili, gumbo, soup they've made. So the saturation of the liquid is on top of the salt. They can't see the salt, but the salt is like heavy underneath. And they feed it to their man, or they feed it to their male children, and they say, "What do you think?" And it's so funny to hear the men that are scared to say anything.
They lie.
They go, "Oh, yeah, it's good." And then you see, like, the dad slap the son and be like, "Say it's good. Say it's good.
Say it's good."
That made me laugh.
This confession says, "I woke up in the morning to pee all over our patio chair. We couldn't figure out quite how our 60-pound lab got on the chair to pee on it, so we had to look at the cameras. And saw, hey, what do you know? It was me sleepwalking."
Really?
Yeah.
That's how you found out you sleepwalk?
The dog's sitting there going,
Wasn't me.
You're right. Poor dogs. Dogs and cats get blamed for some stuff that ain't right, y'all.
Yep. Somebody confessing, they said, "Growing up, I was secretly sleeping with all my sister's good friends."
Whoa.
Probably no secret. It always comes out, Kev.
Think so? Okay. This confession says, "Anytime I go to any of my in-laws' family functions, I use my 5-year-old as a nice distraction so I don't have to mingle." Hmm. I think a lot of people will do that. They'll use their kids as a buffer to not have to associate with a lot of adults.
To go back on the other one, if you're going to hook up with your sister's friend, don't. That's all I got.
There's a story there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I want it.
I woke up to my sister telling my mom, "You know, Jason hooked up with blah, blah, blah." "What? He did what?"
Chaos.
Oh, I heard the whole thing in the house. It was awful.
This confession says, "I'm only 24, but I'm already so exhausted. I feel like I can't catch up with life." That's a 24-year-old that feels that way.
Dang.
Yeah, honestly, it is. It's legit. It's reality. There's so many people out there that are just, they feel like they're holding on by a thread.
Go get your blood work done, because it could be a bunch of things, too, making you sluggish that you don't even realize.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, and it might
24,
be
24, that is too young.
And at any age, you can say yes to too many things as well.
I think, too, you have to be honest with yourself and say, "I got to make some adjustments. This is not the way it's supposed to be."
We're not machines.
No,
you're a human.
You have one life. What are you doing?
Yeah. This confession says, "I know my boss tends to like girls much younger than him. So the week leading up to the yearly review for my raise, I wore my hair in pigtails and made sure to smile. And I told him good morning every day, and I got a 10% raise."
10%?
All right, we'll put it's a my, lot of work.
Putting my hair in pigtails tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you think you can pigtail it up?
I might get 2%.
This confession says, "I missed a huge deadline at work, and when my boss asked, I panicked and faked an anxiety attack. So they sent me to the doctor, and seeing no options, I carried on the deception, and now I'm on paid sick leave for depression and burnout symptoms."
Wow.
That's another person that's really having to stick to it. It's kind of like the person faking the Crohn's disease.
That one's easier, the depression and anxiety. I don't feel I'm sad.
Don't we all have a little bit of that?
Every human walking the planet suffers from some form of depression. Fight me.
It's real.
It's real.
This person confesses. They said, "My wife had an affair. He bought her an expensive watch, and after the affair ended, she told me she had gotten rid of it. I found it. She didn't get rid of it."
Oh.
So what did I do? I sold it, kept the money. Hmm. Okay.
Well, now we're in a whole tit for tat.
Yeah, we are.
And I'm not trying to live my life like that.
No.
Yeah. And here's the thing about staying with a cheater.
It's always going to be in your head. And they may never cheat on you again, but now you're going to live a lifetime of stress and worry. Some people can do it and some people can't.
Yeah.
That's why for me, because I am the kind of person, I can forgive somebody. I really can. I would not be able to forget. As soon as you're 15 minutes late.
Right.
Are you at Jake's house again?
Every time you say you're working late, yeah, you're thinking, okay, you're working late on Jake.
Mm-hmm.
You'll never be in a place of peace. And shouldn't a relationship be a happy place of peace?
Look, yeah. if you're gonna cheat on me, just lie to me really good. Just be good as a liar.
Be as good as a liar as Jake is in bed.
Exactly.
This confession says, I'm a dad of 3 grown daughters, and each of them secretly say to me, I know I'm your favorite. And I always tell them, yes, you are, but don't tell the others.
That's a funny game.
That is.
It's harmless.
And this dad confessing, he says, earlier this week, my 4-year-old daughter asked me whilst we were getting changed after swimming, Daddy, why is your penis so chunky? I've never felt so flattered and horrified at the same time.
It's a weird place to be in.
That is a weird place to be in.
That's a compliment, though. I mean, chunky is fat.
Yeah, I guess guys are like that, but you don't want it coming from your 4-year-old daughter.
No, that whole thing makes me feel weird. I hate
it. Yes. He's a little conflicted.
I don't like it.
Put on some pants and get it together.
Yeah.
I don't think you can change in front of her anymore. This is weird.
And how about this? My dad and I have played rummy every weekend over the last year. I've never beaten him, and it's the happiest I ever have seen him since mom passed last year.
You can't let him lose.
Yeah.
You gotta let him win, dog.
That's it. Gotta let dad win. Makes him happy. Love all your confessions. You can send them to us, 877-979-WRMF, 877-979-9763. Coming up, got your whacked out news, and they caught the guy that stole those 2 monkeys from the Dallas Zoo. We'll give you the details next.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories, dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. Something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Whacked out news.
People breaking the law. Ha ha, fighting in the nude. Ha. Drunk people pooping in the street. Ha ha, it's the whacked out news. So many people on meth. Ow!
I got some animal news here for you. First off, it is an update. Remember those monkeys that disappeared from the Dallas Zoo?
Yes.
They found the guy that took them. It was 24-year-old Davion Irvin. He has now been charged with 6 counts of animal cruelty, 2 counts of burglary, and was behind bars yesterday on $25,000 bond. He claims he's an animal lover, and what he did was he went to the Dallas Zoo and cut the enclosure that allowed a clouded leopard to escape. Remember, that was the first one, and they thought somebody was coming in and messing with the cages. Apparently, he wanted to take the clouded leopard, but only had time to pet it before the clouded leopard escaped to the top of her enclosure.
Oh, my.
Right.
How do you, like, think it's a good idea to pet a leopard?
I get it. He's an animal lover, Virginia.
I know, but, like, leopard, wild cat,
You feel like you have a connection with the leopard, and I understand how this could happen.
He admitted to taking the 2 Emperor Tamarin monkeys after that and says that he took them on the city's light rail train after leaving the zoo.
Wow, these monkeys went on an adventure.
He then kept them at that abandoned house. That's where they found them, in the closet.
Yes.
Apparently, he had a number of other animals there as well with fish food. They had gone missing from the zoo earlier in January, but they had not been reported stolen at the time.
How bizarre.
It really is. That was his whole thing. He was trying to empty out the zoo and put the animals in an abandoned house so he could
enjoy them. 1 by 1 and 2 by 2, I'm going to empty out your damn zoo.
Yeah, what the heck?
Is that on the top of the dome?
Yeah.
I love it. Okay.
And this is a crazy story. You got to watch and not let your dog eat poo, because one did in England and almost died this week. Apparently, the poo, they believe, came from a meth head.
Oh, no.
And they say if a smaller dog had eaten it, it would have died.
And what sucks is people are going to start eating this stuff, trying to get high from meth poop. You know what's going to happen.
That's so repulsive.
I agree.
Yeah. Yeah, that might be a deal breaker.
That's definitely a deal breaker.
You shouldn't be allowed to walk amongst us if you eat meth poo to get high.
You're an animal.
Yeah.
You can't be here.
But you know, if people found out that you could get high from that, it would happen. You know that, right?
It's so gnarly.
I know.
And a crazy, twisted story that everybody needs to know about that is happening here in South Florida and has for a while. 2 pet horses were stolen and their bodies were then found slaughtered with the remains dumped in Southwest Miami-Dade.
It's such a crazy story. And I had no idea this was going on. My girlfriend who runs Rescue Life, Meg, called me and her husband called me. They actually rescued these 2 horses years ago and rehabbed them and gave them to this family in Miami-Dade. This is their pets.
Yeah.
These 2 horses were in an enclosure with a fence, and they were loved, and they were ridden, and they were cared for like pets. So imagine somebody goes in your backyard and steals your... It's like they're 2 dogs. They're 2 horses.
Right.
Steals your 2 dogs, slaughters them for meat, and then leaves their heads and bodies in the canal.
Oh, yeah. I would,
2 miles from where they were stolen.
I turn it at John Wick up in here.
This is a thing. People are stealing horses and murdering them, and these are people's pets.
I would turn into John Wick, and I could do that now because I've been taking YouTube karate, and I do feel pretty...
I feel like you would get it.
Ready for somebody to step.
My friends would love to have you on the task force. They want the governor to notice this and take this seriously and put a task force together to prosecute.
Yeah, they definitely need to do something about it. They say in the United States, 40,000 horses a year are being stolen and slaughtered. And you might say, who wants horse meat? Apparently, there are some people that do. Like, for instance, in Cuba, people believe that eating horse meat will cure things like AIDS and cancer, apparently.
They have Horse Meat Monday.
It's disgusting. This is somebody's pet. Mm-hmm. What the hell is going on? My friends, Rescue Life is the name of their charity, and they have put together $10,000 for information leading to the arrest of the 2 people that took these horses and murdered them. Within minutes of doing it, the horses were slaughtered. And sometimes they slaughter these horses with a blowtorch while they're still alive.
Can you imagine?
No, it's completely brutal. It's inhumane. It's terrible, the whole story about it. And that's why, just to create a little bit of awareness that this unfortunately is going on. Because, yeah, they say they do it so quick, it's hard to catch up with them. It is illegal to slaughter horses for meat in the state of Florida. And listen to this. If you're stealing a horse, the punishment right now on the books in Florida is listed as death by hanging.
But that is also listed as cruel and barbaric, so they won't do it.
Right.
So there's the loophole.
Yeah. Seems like an old-timey kind of a rule there. Death by hanging.
Death do by even do that? Hanging.
Does a state do that anymore?
No, they don't. So this is how DeSantis needs to swoop in, and the FWC and whoever else needs to get a task force together, rewrite this law, make it punishable by something other than an archaic way, like hanging.
I don't know. I can see DeSantis is going for a death by hanging.
It's weird. Not that they don't deserve it. If you do this to a horse, you do deserve death by hanging.
Are we sure there's not one state that still has the death by hanging? Not to say they practice it, but it may not be illegal. Okay.
Yeah.
Because every now and then you go, oh, there's no way that would ever happen. Then you go into it and go, dang, they still have death by hanging.
I don't think they would do that.
Okay. All right.
But that's why the governor needs to look at it and make it punishable by a real amount of jail time, a real sentence, and go after these people. But in the meantime, if anybody wants $10,000 cash and they know who took these horses in Miami-Dade, call Crime Stoppers.
It looks the last American hanging that was legit for, you know, the death penalty, 1972.
Okay.
According to my sources, I'm about 38% right.
All right. Well, there's a passenger aboard a Delta flight from Orlando to New York that accused a flight attendant of telling his wife that she had a stupid face. Apparently,
what?
The couple had tried using a first-class overhead bin and had some issues with it, and then had an exchange with the flight attendant while trying to get her help. The crew member replied, "I don't care. Don't do it, because I will turn this plane back and get you off. Don't press my buttons." The flight attendant then added, "You're being rude. Rude since the moment at the back." Thomas Todd is the husband's name. And he started then filming the video, and apparently the flight attendant got upset because he wasn't really paying attention to her doing the demonstration on the safety, and she said, "You might learn something." And so that kind of got her upset. And then the flight attendant then looks at his wife, Jen, and says, "Don't look at me with that stupid face."
Oh.
And then Jen looks at her and asks her what she just said, and then the lady says that she's from the Bronx and says, "You don't want this."
You actually don't want the Bronx.
Yeah.
They come in hot.
Here's a little bit of the audio from the video.
"I will turn this plane back. You got the wrong one today.
Well, I have you on video saying my wife has a stupid face. So
you're being rude.
I don't care. You're being rude." So I guess she didn't deny saying his wife had a stupid face.
I want to hear the audio from the beginning.
Yeah.
That's the great thing about these audios. It's manipulated, and you don't hear what happened in the beginning and what everybody said.
Yeah. Well, the husband said that the plane was returned to the gate. Several people were removed from the flight because the crew member felt unsafe. They were rebooked on another flight and upgraded to first class. And he said on Twitter that Delta asked him to remove his post so they could take care of us, but complained that he's still been waiting since November for the compensation they said they would give. Hasn't happened yet. There's also a couple in Tulsa that's waiting for their refund. They went to get two coffees at a Starbucks, and they wound up with a $4,444 tip.
For two coffees?
For two coffees.
That's a little high.
Apparently,
I know Starbucks is always high.
Yeah.
But.
That's ridiculous. Apparently what happened was the number four stuck on the tip button.
Oh.
Yeah. That's what they're saying it is, at least.
It was $4,444.44. This is a real shock. We contacted their customer service helpline probably 30, 40 times that day. They assured us that they are sending new checks. But as of today, we still have not fully finished the situation. We still haven't received checks.
Wow. And they had a trip to Thailand to see her sister she hasn't seen in 17 years that they had to cancel because they don't have that money.
Yeah, that's your travel money.
Yeah, exactly.
Dang, Starbucks. You better clean this up.
Mm-hmm.
To go back to the hanging thing, I'm looking it up. We might be wrong. I think New Hampshire still, you can technically get hung there, but they don't practice it anymore. Okay. It's still on the books.
Yeah, I don't think anybody would practice it.
I think it's still there, though.
I know, but that's why this needs to be something that the governor changes the books.
Mm-hmm. Agreed. I'm just saying, it's still. We say there's no way any state has it. We're getting called out.
So. We have it.
The hanging.
We said we have it. Mm-hmm. We do absolutely have it. Yeah. But then it also says that hanging is cruel and unusual punishment, and it's not a way to take somebody's life. So it's like contradictory.
It really is.
Let's redo the law and make it punishable by an actual real jail sentence.
Another scam that is kind of going on here, or at least somebody wanting their refund, in Dade City, garbage collectors took a family's outdoor furniture by mistake, threw it in the garbage truck, and drove off.
This happens.
Yeah, I think they were getting their house pressure washed, so they put everything out in the front yard, and the garbage people were like, okay, they took a glass tabletop, like throw that in there. Oh. Four pieces of outdoor wicker furniture. Oh. That goes. Two antique rocking chairs.
Oh.
Three window screens. All gone. The only thing they left was the welcome mat.
That sucks.
He cost $915. So a spokesperson said that it was a mistake, happens from time to time, and they said the right thing to do was to cover the costs. Just don't know when they will get their costs covered. That is the big question. So there you go. And that is your whacked out news. Coming up here in a couple of minutes, we got some real or fake Florida headlines. Can you tell the difference? What do you think about this one, Virginia? Real or fake? Police say man with no hands and no legs is armed and on the run.
That's a great joke.
Okay, real or fake? You'll find out next.
From the WRMF Anajar and Levine Accident Attorneys Traffic Center. If you've been in an accident, call the law offices of Anajar and Levine at 1-800-747-FREE. That's 1-800-747-3733.
At the moment, you're moving slowly through Delray Beach on 95 southbound. We have a crash beyond Atlantic Avenue that's blocking two right lanes. Give yourself plenty of extra time through that area. Traffic a service of Palm Beach Mitsubishi. I'm Suits, 979 WRMF.
The brand new Palm Beach Mitsubishi is the local leader in customer service with the best selection of fully reconditioned pre-owned cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs. Palm Beach Mitsubishi, across from the Palm Beach Airport. PalmBeachMitsubishi.com.
Did you hear about Taco Bell's apology? Yeah, they apologized for going too far with their breakfast. Like the naked egg taco and chicken biscuit nachos? It was too much. All you need in the morning is tasty, simple food. Like the breakfast crunch wrap. Fluffy eggs, melty cheese, sausage, crispy hash browns, wrapped in a warm tortilla. Or, as some call it, a breakfast crunch thing. Grab one today, only at Taco Bell. At participating U.S. Taco Bell stores during breakfast hours only until 11 a.m. while supplies last. Contact local store for hours and participation, which vary.
What's better than one slice of pizza from Racetrack to get you going? How about two slices of pizza? And when you buy one slice, you can get any other for $1. Ayo, you can buy one slice of pepperoni for now and get the new bacon cheeseburger pizza for later for just $1. Or just get two slices for now. Buy one, get one for $1 slices. Get you going. Oh, I like that. We should put that on a t-shirt or something. Racetrack, whatever gets you going. Limited time item only at participating locations.
These days, $10 doesn't get you very far. But with Brightline, guests can ride to a shopping spree in Aventura or the new brunch spot in West Palm Beach everyone's talking about. Or to the next Miami Heat game. Brightline makes getting to everything South Florida has to offer easier than ever. Enhance your experience with in-station and onboard amenities like lounge access, crafted cocktails, and more. Book your next ride at GoBrightline.com.
What you've heard about probiotics is probably wrong.
I eat yogurt, so I don't need to take a probiotic.
Probiotics? They don't really work.
It's time to learn the truth about probiotics and join the Align Healthy Gut team up. Align has probiotics to naturally help relieve occasional bloating, gas, and abdominal discomfort. Try Align probiotics for a month and see how great a healthy gut can feel. Get $2 off your first month of Align at AlignProbiotics.com.
Thank you.
There's a lot of things in this world happening right now, and consumers like myself want some level of control.
My name is Chrissy Lee. I have worked for FPL for 7 years. I get to be on the forefront of the best technology to produce clean energy. Solar is a stable fuel source, which will lead to stable bills and ultimately will produce savings for our customers.
I know that FPL is looking at other ways that down the line will reduce my bill.
Learn how FPL is investing in Florida's future at FPL.com/value.
Life doesn't stop when the economy is uncertain. The market might not care you have a wedding to plan or a kid to put through school. And inflation doesn't know you've got a family to feed. But Bank of America does and is here to help. With digital tools to help you save and local experts in the Palm Beaches and Treasure Coast, you can keep life moving forward the way you need it to. Bank of America, what would you like the power to do? Learn more at bofa.com/Palm Beach County. Bank of America N.A. Member FDIC Equal Credit Opportunity Lender.
It is crazy how much your hormones regulate how you feel and how you look and how you live. At Begin A New Med Spa, we really got intensive with my blood work and looking at everything. And now that I feel like I'm in the early stages of menopause, it's so nice to get a little help from Begin A New Med Spa when it comes to regulating my hormones. I've reduced all the food cravings. I actually reduced the night sweats and the hot flashes. I feel better. I have energy. The brain fog is gone. Like, so many things were happening to me. If you're putting on weight and you're fat in places that should be skinny and you're skinny in places that should be fat, trust me, I know what you're going through. And at Begin Anew, they know as well and they can help. Go online today. Set up your appointment. They're easy to find right there on Indian Town Road in the Fresh Market Plaza in Jupiter. Go to beginanewmed.com.
The Jupiter Seafood Festival is coming Saturday and Sunday, February 18th and 19th. Live music, family entertainment, and of course, fresh seafood. Saturday, live on stage, it's Bad Fish, a tribute to Sublime. Plus, Cashed Out, the Bryce Allen Band, and the Leafy Greens. Sunday, it's Rogue Theory with special guest Burnt Biscuit. Kids 12 and under are free. VIP available each day with 2-hour open bar. The Jupiter Seafood Festival at Carlin Park in Jupiter. Get tickets now at Eventbrite.com.
Join Peggy Adams Animal Rescue League's 22nd annual Walk for the Animals on Saturday, February 25th, returning to the Meyer Amphitheater in downtown West Palm Beach. The walk is sure to be a tail wagging good time. Register today at walkwithpeggy.org.
Start the day with Dunkin' and the KBJ Show, the official coffee of 97.9 WRMF. Take your medium or larger coffee in one hand and grab a dollar donut in the other. Limited time offer, terms apply, exclude specialty donuts.
When you enter a place of business, you're owed a legal duty that the place of business is safe for you to shop in. Yet many times, a normal day ends with injuries because that business breached that duty. Slip and falls where cleaning and maintenance were ignored. Falling boxes and items stacked too high. I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. If you suffered an injury at a place of business, our duty is to protect you after that harm. Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm. ForThePeople.com.
I know it works because I've seen it work with my wife. Sometimes you get to that point in life where your body just has a slowing metabolism and there's really not a lot you can do with it. Maybe a hormone imbalance, and especially when you get close to menopause, it can be really hard to lose the weight. That's why Red Mountain Weight Loss was so key for my wife, getting her metabolism going and her hormones in balance. And it all starts with their RM3, an all-natural hormone that burns fat from your belly, hips, and thighs. You can lose 20 pounds by this time next month with the RM3 from Red Mountain Weight Loss. Imagine getting back to your ideal body weight. You can do it. And all the while eating real fresh food. You're not going to feel starved or deprived, and it's not a stimulant, so you're not going to feel nervous or jittery. Want to jump on it and see the same kind of success my wife did? You can schedule your online consultation by dialing #250 from your cell phone and use the keyword Red Mountain Weight Loss.
Good Greek, moving and storage, your superhero movers.
From the Greenway Kia of West Palm Beach Studio. Trade in and trade up to a new Kia for less with one of the area's largest selections of new Kias available. This is 97.9 WRMF Palm Beach.
All right, so are these headlines real or are they made up? We'll see if you can tell the difference here in real or fake Florida headlines. Got Virginia going up against Denny's here, head-to-head little battle.
Come on, D.
Okay.
All right, here. Are these Jaybird written?
Yes, the ones that are fake are.
Okay, you have to go into the mind of Bird. It's a scary place.
No, I dialed it back. You ain't going to break through this round. I dialed it back. It's hard.
So what do you think about this first one here, Virginia? Real or fake Florida headline. Police say man with no hands and no legs is armed and on the run. Real or fake?
That feels like straight out of Florida. I want it to be true so bad. Show me true.
Real it is.
That is so Florida.
Oh, my God. He probably lives in Lake Worth.
I remember Kevin talking about that. Yeah. You reported on that.
Yeah, that's quite a story.
That guy's a star. Is he still out
there?
They
never caught him. I don't know.
I need this guy in my life.
No hands, no legs. Armed, ironically, and on the run.
Good for him.
Good for him. Yes. I mean, I agree. Go out in that blaze of glory, boo.
Oddly enough, I don't want him to ever be caught.
Me either.
That's wrong.
Hasn't he been through enough?
Yeah.
I mean, bro has no extremities.
I'm pulling for you, bro.
I know he's wrong, but I am on his side.
We're pulling for you because you can't pull nothing.
Yeah. What about this, Denny's? Real or fake? Florida convict tased after licking jury member's face.
Ooh.
Real or fake on that one?
Gosh, that feels like Florida too.
Gosh, it really does. Licking face in a courtroom.
Damn.
Mm-hmm. Does that hold water?
I like how he's working it out.
Yeah.
We have to.
Yeah.
We take this seriously.
You got the officer in there, and they probably would have to tase, right, so they don't accidentally shoot someone.
Bailiffs love to tase.
They're so much ready. I can see that happening here in Florida.
So you're going to go with real?
Let's do it.
Okay, it's not. That one is fake. That one
we
is
we just wanted
fake.
It too much, Denny's.
I wanted it.
But I bet if you dug deep enough, you might find a story out there where that's happened.
Oh, I love it when it goes down in the courtroom. I'm sure the judge doesn't like it, but when there's chaos, that's awesome.
What do you think about this one, Virginia? Florida man arrested for directing traffic while also urinating. Is that a real Florida headline?
Again, I want it to be true.
They're tough.
They're tough because we've seen crazier stuff than that.
Absolutely.
I'm going to say it's real.
You're going to go with real. You are correct again. That really did happen.
Can I have the video?
Yeah, I know.
Sure, it's out there.
It has to be.
Denny's, what do you think? Real or fake? Florida couple trapped in unlocked closet for 2 days. Trapped in unlocked closet.
Open the door.
You know, day two, he's like, did you try the door?
What are they on?
Yeah.
Gosh. Real or fake?
Getting locked in a closet for 2 days.
Yeah.
Unlocked. Gosh, I could see that happening. I could see that being a headline. I'm going to go real.
Gonna go real with a question mark. It is real, Denny.
Okay. Wow.
The story on that, the cops opened the door. They didn't even open it. They go, guys, hello. They were
it wasn't
get us
locked.
Out. Yeah,
get us out.
Were they on anything?
Yeah, I believe they were.
They had to have been because that's insane.
Insane.
I think they were running from something and hid in the closet.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Was it a dragon?
It was a dragon.
Yeah. Put down the mushrooms.
All right, Virginia, what do you think about this? Real or fake Florida headline. Florida man claims King Tut's ghost told him to burn down the Waffle House.
That's
real
weird.
Or fake?
I'm such a fan of the videos on TikTok when it goes down at a Waffle House.
Oh, yeah.
And it does.
Oh, it does.
Oh, it does.
It's not a matter of when, it's how.
Have you seen the one where the Waffle House chick catches the chair?
Yes, it's amazing.
They chuck a chair at her, Kevin. With one hand.
Yeah. Just grabs it and then pushes it aside.
Yeah. One hand?
The guy throws the chair. She catches it with one hand, sets it, and then goes right back into arguing.
Waffle House superhero.
How do I not know about this?
Yeah, you need to get on it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think this one's real.
Gonna go fake on this? You're perfect so far, and you're gonna stay that way, Virginia. That is
fake.
Wow.
I came in here and I dominated your game.
Denny's, what do you think about this? Real or fake Florida headline. Florida principal arrested after kidnapping school rival's mascot.
Gosh, I hope it's true because I like the rivalry between these schools.
It'd be great, too, and the fact that the principal is in there and got arrested.
He's in on the prank.
Kicking it up.
So caught up in it.
I got to go true again. I think that's true.
Got to go true, Denny's. I want to smoke.
I wanted it too much.
Not true, unfortunately. No, it didn't happen. Okay, Virginia, three in a row you got. Let's see if you can make it four with this real or fake Florida headline. Florida man calls 911 after his PlayStation stops working.
I get it. Those things are expensive.
Hello, 911.
And you're flustered after. You don't know what to do.
You're trying to play Call of Duty.
Yeah.
So you call a cop?
What do you think, Virginia, real or fake?
I mean, you can't be that dumb, right? But again, it is Florida, so I'm going to go real.
Gotta go real. You're right again.
Crushing it.
Wow, really?
Yep. You're doing well.
Four in a row.
Very impressed.
Thank you.
Denny's, what about this, real or fake? Florida man arrested for calling 911 after his cat was denied entry into a strip club.
You can't bring it to the buffet.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah, we already got it in here.
Tons.
Yeah.
I'm going to say that's true because I stand with the strip club.
You're going to say true? That one is real.
Okay.
I can see that so going down. A guy all hopped up on something. Me and my cat can't get in.
Okay, Virginia, for a perfect score in real or fake Florida headlines, what is this? Florida couple missing after allegedly buying tickets to Middle Earth. Maybe they got there.
The Florida couple is missing.
Yep.
They can't find them, and they had purchased tickets to Middle Earth.
J.R.R. Yep. Tolkien's mystery world or fantasy world.
Danny clearly knows about Middle Earth.
Yeah.
Huh.
Fact or fiction? What do you think? Real or fake?
It's weird. I'm going to say fake.
You're going to say fake?
I don't know.
Perfect score. Virginia got it.
Oh, look at that.
That is fake.
That got too weird.
It's weird, though. I think they do sell trips to take, I guess it's in New Zealand, right? The mountains. You can do the exact hike they did to Mordor.
Oh, no way.
Weird, right?
What the hell is that?
It's where they're throwing the ring, Virginia.
Hey, if you don't know, Lord of the Rings.
She don't know about that.
But I think you could buy tickets and do the same walk they did from, is it Peter Jackson who directed that?
Yeah,
I guess it's the same trek they filmed on.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, weird, right?
That's kind of cool. You're a big Lord of the Rings
nerd.
Dressed
like an elf.
Talk to her about onion rings, not Lord of the Rings.
Oh, I do love onion rings. BurgerFi has the best.
They are good.
Okay, Denny's. This will determine if you win the game or not. You're 2 for 2, right? Or 2 for 4, so you got half of them right. Final one for you, real or fake Florida headline. Florida man walks into stranger's home, removes clothes, and then starts shouting, 5, 6, 7, 8, grandma, grandma.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, that's such an odd story.
Is that a real or a fake headline?
I guess I'm going to say real because it's so specific and insane.
Grandma! That is real.
Don't answer him, Grandma.
Wow.
He's counting and then he's yelling for Grandma.
Could you imagine waking up to that?
No, it'd be rough.
I would think it's my last moments.
Me too.
Wow.
You have the right to...
shoot him.
I think you have the right to do anything in that case.
Okay. He's good as dead.
That person can get whatever.
He's not going to get to the second grandma. Oh. Coming up here in just a couple minutes, are sleepovers over? Nobody doing it anymore? And if you are, should you stop? I'll break it down for you next.
Get the KVJ Show on your smart speaker anytime. Just say, play the KVJ Show.
Mr. Clean, Mr. Clean.
I hate the struggle of tough, greasy messes on my stovetop. So I just freak, wipe, and I'm done.
When I'm frustrated with stubborn bathtub soap scum, I just freak, wipe, and I'm done.
Mr. Clean Clean Freak delivers an innovative cleaning experience with a powerful, deep cleaning mist that starts working on contact to break down tough messes in seconds.
Just freak, wipe, done.
I love the way my windows look. Finally finished up every single window in the house. It really makes such a difference. The house is so quiet now. I'm going to save on my power bill. My insurance goes down. My home value goes up. And the team from BNT brought out the experts. They brought out a team of like seven guys, master installers at BNT that really know their stuff. And they use custom PGT windows and doors. And PGT just makes the best-selling window and door on the market. So when you want the capable, amazing, intelligent, and awesome crew, you gotta call BNT Windows and Doors. They will do it right the first time. Set it up online today at BNTWindowsAndDoors.com.
Join Peggy Adams Animal Rescue League's Walk for the Animals on Saturday, February 25th at the Meyer Amphitheater in downtown West Palm Beach. It's the year of the superhero, so come dressed as your favorite hero. Bring your four-legged friend and enjoy a fun-filled day along the beautiful waterfront. Sponsored by Hills Pet Nutrition. The event starts at 8 a.m. and features vendors, an auction, and the best pet costume contest around. Register today at walkwithpeggy.org.
I grew up down here in South Florida, so for me, it's a little bit more personal. The Mesman in Dover is about community for us. For me, you all are our people, our friends, our family, our future. The difference we will make for you, your kids, and your loved ones matters, because to us, it's personal. Hi, my name is Victor DeMesman from DeMesman and Dover Law Firm. If you need us, call us anytime, 24/7 at 866-954-MORE. That's 866-954-6673. DeMesman and Dover Law Firm, youraccidentattorneys.com. Main office, Fort Lauderdale.
Get results now at New Radiance Cosmetic Centers. It's Randy West. You've got to follow my weight loss journey on Semiglutide Medical Weight Loss Diet. I'm excited to lose the weight with Semiglutide. You've heard about this, by the way, as Ozempic. All the celebrities are talking about it. It's showing dramatic results. It makes you feel full so you don't overeat. You lose 1 to 2 pounds per week. You can call 561-600-THIN. That's 561-600-THIN to schedule your free consultation at South Florida's number one provider of med spa and anti-aging services. Locations in Boca, Fort Lauderdale, Port St. Lucie, Wellington, and Palm Beach Gardens. 561-600-THIN or go to newradiancenow.com/WRMF.
Why pay for electricity if you can get it a lot cheaper by creating it yourself? This is what rooftop solar is all about, saving you tons of money. Imagine a monthly electric bill of $8. It could be a reality. They find that people in Florida are saving $600 to $800, $1,000, maybe more, all depending upon what's going on with your home. And now Florida is one of the most solar-friendly states in America. All kinds of incentives, and the cost of rooftop solar has decreased 70% in the past decade. So get your free home solar assessment right now with Hans Solar, South Florida's number one solar professional, to see how much you can save. You'll start by paying nothing down out of pocket, and you can qualify for no payments up to 1 year. Just go online right now to HansSolar.com. HANSOLAR.com.
I'm Mark Anajar.
I'm Glenn Levine.
I'm Ellie Anajar.
Together, we're Anajar and Levine.
If you've been hurt in a car crash, we'll fight to get you the maximum compensation you deserve.
Call Anajar and Levine for your free consultation. 1-800-747-FREE.
In office, West Palm Beach.
Music this hour.
Sponsored by Jackson Hewitt. Need bucks with Jackson Hewitt? Don't wait weeks for the IRS to send your tax refund. Come in today for up to $3,500 with a no-interest, no-fee refund advance loan when you file your taxes at Jackson Hewitt. For eligible clients, loans by Republic Bank and Trust Company. Details at jacksonhewitt.com.
When you need a laugh, you need our mobile app. Download it free. Just search 97.9 WRMF. Now back to the KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.
So our sleepovers... over? Should you stop doing them, or have kids already stopped doing it? I notice my son Cannon doesn't do a ton of them. A few here or there. It seems like he will connect with his friends through the video games, and they will be able to see each other, or he'll be on, you know, a chat with them, and they'll be playing video games together, but not so much going over to each other's house, which I remember was always such a big thing when I was growing up. And now there are even some experts who view sleepovers as key for developing independence and flexibility in kids. But there are some that are saying, no, I don't think you should be doing the sleepovers. In fact, some have a no sleepovers rule. rule, and they say it's been gaining traction in some parenting circles for a while. The reasons being is some parents who are protective believe that sleepovers open the door for risky decisions, loss of sleep, as well as bullying or abuse, especially sexual abuse.
Yeah. I mean, I don't want to say I was abused because I was a teenager, so I went along with the party, but that's where I was kind of introduced into romantic touching, was on a sleepover by a girl that I was friends with's older brother.
Oh, wow.
And it wasn't like he was only like a few months. He was like, they were Irish twins. So, but that's why I always told Magnolia, you can't do sleepovers if there's an older brother. And that became a rule in my house because of, you know, what I was exposed to.
Look, I feel like anything in life, you can look at the terrible things of it. I'm sure, yes, there's terrible sleepover stories, but there's also good sleepover stories, too. And I think you can live in both worlds here and have a level of protection to where you can keep the kids safe.
And how well do you know these parents that are watching the kids? Like, if you know them and you know their parenting style and it's the same as yours, great. If you trust them.
I'm just not a big fan of blanket statements of, do not let your kids ever sleep over at someone's. Well, yes, you're right. If you don't know the parents and if there's a situation you're not familiar with, then there's some caution there. But to say it's bad, I don't know.
Here's a psychologist telling you why he does not allow his children to do sleepovers.
Sleepovers often provide the right opportunity for kids to get into things that are way over their head, whether they intend to or not. And so if my intention is for my child to have wonderful and close relationships with their kids, with their peers, and for me to have a close relationship with my child, I'm going to make sure that they do that in a situation and time that is most likely to be profitable for them and less likely to leave them scarred with trauma from which they might need to heal for the rest of their lives.
Uh-huh. Oh,
boy, that's a lot. It's a lot, Kevin.
He said some of the dangers include the temptation of technology to use when the parents go to bed, kids get in trouble when they're together, and you could even have the parents going out of the house and hiring a babysitter. So what they recommend, if you are going to be doing a sleepover, make sure you do your due diligence. One, know the family, their dynamic, and their house rules before agreeing to the sleepover. Just don't turn your kid over to strangers.
Duh.
Yeah.
I mean, well, yeah, of course.
And know who's going to be there, too, because sometimes a weird uncle can just, like, pop in, and that's weird.
I'm just saying, I was allowed to a few sleepovers in my time, and I would say that was the best moments of growing.
Patty Fitzgerald, who is the founder of SafelyEverAfter.com, recommends no sleepovers before the age of 8. So if you're in third or fourth grade, that's where you could start them.
Because when you're littler, you can be more manipulated. And as you get older, I think you find your voice a little more.
She said the kids also need to know what to do and say if they're put in a compromising situation. Kind of work over the script with them. So if they are caught with something that they're like, whoa, they're taken aback, it's awkward, they don't know how to react. If you rehearse that with them, then maybe they will. She said, make sure that your kid always has access to a phone so that they can call if something is not quite right. And also make sure you have a safe word so that if they do call, they don't feel weird and they don't have to tell the whole story of what's going on. They can say, llama, for instance, and you would know that something's up and go get them just when they say that.
But everything you've just said, you could insert sleepover with kids going to the mall, kids hanging out too long. I mean, kids are going to... just insert problem here.
Sure, absolutely. So if you're looking at the precautions that are out there and what you can take, I don't know that I would be a shut down the sleepover parent myself, but I think that at least knowing the right steps is good. And if you're caught in the middle and say maybe one parent is okay with the sleepover, one is not, one compromise could be what they call a sleep under, not a sleep over.
What?
Oh, boy. Kevin, the longer you read.
What is that?
This is where a child will head to a friend's house for dinner in their pajamas. They eat dinner with the friend and their family. They watch a movie and play together. But then when it's bedtime, they get get picked up. It's kind of like a nighttime play date without the chance of staying up late without supervision and, you know, that older brother coming in and introducing you to improper touching.
And by the way, a lot of stories coming in. What about the older sister?
That can happen too. It didn't happen to me. It was an older brother, but yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All of it's possible. And you just need to be aware of it. This happens. Are you going to be freaked out and accusing people before anything happens? I don't think you should do that either. But if you don't want your kids introduced to stuff like this and you know the house is loose, they might get introduced to stuff like this.
Yeah. Well, you could restrict your kid from sleepovers, but they're going to die earlier in life. That's at least the story I've got for you next. So it's kind of a back and forth about how protective do I need to be as a parent.
I don't even
Wait, I'm molested or die?
I don't have kids and this is annoying me.
Yes. You protect. Just saying, you don't know what your kid's going to get into. Make sure you know the family well if you are going to do it, or your kid's going to be in trouble. But now then there's another study that is coming out today where they're finding that children who have more freedom and get things like sleepovers have a better chance of living longer. So you know what, Virginia, as a parent, you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't.
You are right about that. You just got to try to navigate the best you can and keep your child breathing.
According to this study they did, they said men who had an overprotective father and little freedom during childhood may be at a 12% higher risk of dying before the age of 80.
But I know why, because you're just taking chances. You want to break free, dog.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's you're right. When you finally get out from underneath the protective thumb, you go crazy, you and may then take, you harm your body.
You may take bigger chances than normal.
It's possible. And they say that women who had an overprotective father, the risk of dying before the age of 80 increases more to 22%.
Really?
For whatever reason. They also suggest that men who live with only one parent during childhood had a 179% higher risk of dying before their 80th birthday.
80. I mean, if I can get to 70,
you're
good, huh? I'm going, man. You know, you had a great run, man.
Yeah.
The things you did.
Count your blessings.
Yes.
Yeah, count your blessings. They say all these participants, though, were born in either the 1950s or 60s.
It's a hard time.
It feels like that was a hard time as a kid to grow up. All you had was like wood blocks to play with. Your shoes didn't look comfortable.
Just by talking to people and looking at stuff, it feels like the 70s started to lighten up a little bit. There was still some hard asses out there, but it started to kind of melt a little bit. Then the 80s, the helicopter parents started to come around. And then the 90s,
Forget about it. It was all lost.
Hell in a handbasket, Virginia.
Yeah, that's it. Coming up here in a couple of minutes, we got an email from a KVJ Nationer who wants to know how they can tell if their fiance is gay. We had an email, I think, on the show last week where a fiance was accused of being gay before a wedding by some bridesmaids. And now there are other listeners of KVJ who are like, is my fiance gay? I'll give you some of her thoughts on this and why she thinks he might be gay next.
Drama, laughs, and fun to start your day. The KVJ Show is back in minutes on 97.9 WRMF.
Too many people settle for really bad internet. You think, I just don't want to hassle with it. It's not that bad. But that's not what you should be saying about your internet. It's not that bad. You know, you don't want to say that about your healthcare or your mechanic. So why would you say that about your internet? You actually can get really great internet that you can be pumped about. And you can say, my internet's awesome. 23 years later, I say my Xfinity internet is awesome. The reason why I love it, the speed, the reliability, the parental controls, and the XFi advanced security. So I am protected from hackers. And listen to this. You can jump on it so easily right now and switch to Xfinity and even get one line of unlimited mobile with 5G and home internet together for just $50 a month for 12 months with no annual contract. And they're even going to throw in a free streaming box. Just go to Xfinity.com, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a local Xfinity store today.
Well, hello, Winn-Dixie. And hello, Big Game Savings. Previously frozen pork baby back, St. Louis style, or spare ribs are BOGO. Touchdown! Oh, my game day faves are on sale too, like snow crab clusters for $10.99 a pound and Hass avocados for 69 cents each. Plus, we're scoring mad points with Winn-Dixie Rewards. Winn-Dixie, it's a win-win. While supplies last, no substitutions or rain checks. Exclusions apply. See stores for details.
What makes the going good? Is it burgers or pizza? One slice or two? At Racetrack, it's all of the above. Stop in for buy one, get one $1 pizza slices and the new bacon cheeseburger pizza. Racetrack, whatever gets you going. Limited time at participating locations.
There's a lot of things in this world happening right now, and consumers like myself want some level of control.
My name is Chrissy Lee. I have worked for FPL for 7 years. I get to be on the forefront of the best technology to produce clean energy. Solar is a stable fuel source, which will lead to stable bills and ultimately will produce savings for our customers.
I know that FPL is looking at other ways that down the line will reduce my bill.
Learn how FPL is investing in Florida's future at FPL.com/value.
For the ones finding new ways to ensure the job always gets done. For the ones wearing many hats. For the ones who are hands-on, even from far away. And the ones keeping business moving forward. We are Grainger, offering professional-grade industrial supplies, plus real-time product availability and access to experts ready to answer your toughest questions. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Are you ready for America's favorite Tupperware lady to blow you away?
See why the LA Times raves. I was laughing too hard to breathe.
Back the truck up. Whoa!
Join Dixie and discover why the Today Show cheers, not your grandmother's Tupperware party.
Is this a real Tupperware party? Yes.
See why audiences the world over love to party with Dixie. Come see Dixie's Tupperware Party at the Kravis Center, February 17th or 19th.
Aware Recovery Care is here to help you or your loved ones recover from addiction to drugs and or alcohol. Aware's one-of-a-kind, Yale-inspired in-home addiction treatment model works using a completely different approach to recovery. Our team of specialists treat people where they live and where their triggers live, and it's designed to achieve a full year of recovery, improving your chances for lasting health and wellness by 80%. Let us help you recover where you live. To learn more, visit awarerecoverycare.com.
It's that time again, that time of year when dollar weed and clover invade southern lawns. This year, grab a bag of Scott's Turf Builder Bonus S and fight back. It's formulated for southern lawns so you'll get the nutrients your grass needs while also killing those pesky invaders. Scott's Turf Builder Bonus S. It's the number one brand in the South and has the 2-in-1 to start your season off right. Satisfaction guaranteed. Scott's, it's lawn season. Pick up a bag of Scott's Bonus S today at your local retailer.
Do you want to find out how to start training for an essential career in healthcare today? With classes in nursing, medical assisting, ultrasound, and other fields in healthcare, students at Southeastern College are preparing to help people lead healthier lives, now and into the future. Some of these programs can even be completed in less than a year. So if you're wondering how you could start training for a new essential career, give Southeastern College a call, 855-561-6164, or visit sec.edu. See you today.
I never really even thought that I needed a water treatment system until I had my hot water heater keep breaking, and the cost was making me infuriated. They said it's just your water. It's got a lot of minerals in it, and you're getting a whole bunch of buildup. So then I would pay $140 every other month to get the thing flushed out. But I don't have to do that now either, because I got Aquaman water treatment systems. They came in, they fixed my water, got rid of the calcification on it, and I've noticed so many other positive changes, not only with my hot water heater. If you have dry skin like I do, you're going to love it, because you won't have that dry skin. It's not hard water now, it's softer. You're going to love what it does to your hair. My wife is like, hey, look at my hair. It's like all poofy and just awesome now. It's got great body to it. And the other thing, too, that's awesome, you'll use less soap to clean your dishes and your bod. Plus, it is much tastier than bottled water. You'll save money there as well. So go where I went online, AquamanWaterSystems.com. That's AquamanWaterSystems.com.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. We recently received a call from an injured person. The insurance company had offered them $11,000. We took the case over and got more than $2 million in court. Morgan & Morgan.
Visit ForThePeople.com for an office near you.
Good Greek Moving and Storage. Your superhero movers.
It's more of the KVJ Show right now on 97.9 WRMF.
Well, this is kind of a tough question. It did come up in last week's Make Up or Break Up, as there was a bride that was wanting to know if she should break up with her bride's maids, get them out of the wedding, because she saw a text thread where they were joking about her fiance being gay and his fashion sense. And one of the bridesmaids showed her that text thread. I think that spurred on this email that we have here from one of our KBJ Nationers. Virginia, if you would read the email, but leave out the name at the end.
That was only
there for communication, yes.
Thank you for telling me that, because I just read the name and I would have totally read
sorry
it.
Sorry about that. Yeah.
You know I'm like Anchorman.
I know. So Anchorman, please do not read after the words, please help.
All right.
I don't want to blow up her spot.
This one's from Mary, and it says, I'm about to get married, and I have doubts about my fiancé. He has very little interest in sex, and I thought maybe it was an ED issue, so I got him meds. But the more I find out about him, the less I trust him. He's very secretive about himself and his past. So in a desperate attempt to find out if I'm crazy or not, I reached out to an ex-girlfriend of his and asked her if they had issues when they were together. Everything she told me about their relationship, it was this exact same way that our relationship is unfolding. The ex shared that she thought he was gay. And for a while, he was obsessed with a friend of his. And she even offered to bring that guy into their relationship because she was desperate to save it. He replied nothing when asked. Also, I had a conversation with the friend he was supposedly obsessed with, and he didn't deny or admit to anything about his sexuality. This relationship has really made me sick emotionally and physically. I'm at the verge of losing my job. Jeez. Please help.
This opened my eyes to this last week when we had this makeup or breakup. How many women are struggling with this? I just can't even imagine this, that you would seriously be questioning whether your husband is gay or not. But man, the stories really started coming through.
Sometimes y'all look at it too black and white. Sometimes some of these people could be bisexual. That's a thing, y'all.
That's right.
We act like that's not a thing. That's a real thing.
That is a thing.
And one person text said, well, if you're suspicious of your fiance being gay, why would you even consider getting married? You know, the one thing is there are so many different sliding scales of this. And how do you really know? What is it? You know, there are some guys that have some mannerisms, or they may be thin and neat and fancy dressers and all these kind of things. And I think it was like a Seinfeld episode.
But all you know, all that does it. That's not real. All that is just stereotypes of that makes people think one thing. That's not a real thing.
Yeah. I love a gay acting straight guy because that's just the best scenario, I think.
Right. And so, you know, you're asking, well, you know, if you're suspicious, there may be other people that, you know, hey, it's anymore too. Things are so fluid that what is one side of the other? Now, I don't know. When do you know how to get out of a serious relationship when you're talking marriage because you just are suspicious and you can't get an answer out of them one way or the other?
You just want somebody that's not going to do you wrong, that's not going to cheat on you, that wants to be. Yeah. If you're getting married, whether what you like and what you're into, you hope you marry somebody that loves you and that's going to stay with you. That's what marriage is about, no?
Yeah.
Typically.
She's already got problems, even aside, and it sounds like part of the reason why she's wondering if her fiance is gay is because they don't have a lot of intimacy in their relationship.
Well, if you are a person that wants intimacy and he's not giving it to you, it doesn't matter what the reason why.
Agreed.
Right.
You talk to him about the ED thing. He took the meds. That didn't fix it. There's your answer.
Boom.
You should not marry this dude.
Sometimes we get so obsessed, why? It ain't working. You're not getting what you need. C'est la vie, and let's not overthink this
thing.
Go
to the bar and go find guys that are interested in sex. I guarantee you, they're there.
Or just go, just get out of the situation. Your heart's not feeling it, and clearly he's not either. Sex is a big deal for a lot of people. You kind of need to be touched if you're in a relationship. Can I get an amen, Rolls?
Preach on, Jay Bird. Tell us about the touches you love.
Being in a relationship where you're not getting touched, where is the fun in that? I can have a Denny's for that one.
One person texted in, they said, yeah, I've been married almost 20 years and all my friends think my husband is gay. So apparently
that part
does happen. Yeah.
I've seen people that are married and I think the husband is gay, but he's not.
And the thing that's different here is from that text, your friends think your husband is gay. This emailer, she thinks her fiance might be gay.
But the problem is not that you think he's gay. The problem is he doesn't want to have sex with you and you want to have sex with him.
Exactly.
That's the issue. And you have to just break it down to that. It doesn't matter if he's gay or not. He's not interested in intimacy with you. If you care about intimacy, he ain't the dude.
It's an odd thing how many people go through these kind of personal problems and they never bring them up to their mate. It's an uncomfortable situation, but I would say what's worse, having that uncomfortable situation before you get married or then marrying somebody and not having that conversation and then finding out something after?
Exactly. Yeah.
Have the uncomfortable conversation.
You said you asked and he really wasn't, you need to get that definitive answer. You need to say, hey, look, here's what's going on. Our lack of intimacy in our relationship makes me wonder if you are gay or straight, and also your relationship with this other guy is questionable. I need to know, are you gay? Are you bisexual? Is there something that is going on here? Because we are engaged.
And why are you
going to get married?
Why are you not attracted to me? Mm-hmm. Why don't you want to sleep with me? That is the question.
And maybe I'm weird, but if I'm engaged with somebody, I'm about to tie the knot and walk down the plank. I am going to have no problem talking about everything we need to talk about. If you can't handle my energy about me bringing up stuff, then we're probably not meant to be there.
You're right. It's got to happen. You should be having uncomfortable conversations before you marry somebody officially.
And he sounds like he's got too many secrets. He won't even talk about his past. Like, what's that?
Trust me on this. You can lose a lot of years in your life by being polite.
Yeah. So you need an uncomfortable conversation, then please email us back and let us know how it goes. And if you've had this same kind of dilemma, you have any suggestions or solutions, 877-979-WRMF. Call or text.
Oh girl, I like you. I do. I want to be a friend. Go shopping in a Benz. I like you. I do. I hit you in a lane. Can you fit me in your plans? I like you. I do. We went up out of France and we woke up in Japan. I like you. I do. Girl, I know you only like it fancy. So I pull up in that Maybach candy. Yeah, your boyfriend, I never understand me. Cause I'm about to pull this girl like a hammy. Let's take a little dip, little lady. Hit PCH, I'm ready. Yeah, I've been thinking lately that I need someone to save me. Now that I'm famous, I got all around me. But I need a good girl, I need someone to crown me. So please be true, don't trip around with me. I need someone to share this heart with me. Feel you are, then run it back again. Oh girl, I like you, I do. I wanna be a friend, go shopping in a Benz. I like you, I do. I hit you in a lane, can you fit me in your plans? I like you, I do. We went up out of France and we woke up in Japan. I like you, I do. I do.
Let me know when you're free, cause I've been trying to hit it all week, babe. Why you acting all sweet? I know that you want a little me. Get a little OT, but it ain't new to a freak. Let me drop bands for that dude in your teeth. He let the way I drip, turn that pool to the beach. And I could have caught the broken, but I cops the lead. Why we got the same taste for the finer things? Brand new with the same routine. Now we got me on a leash, cause we set no strings. You know I'm cool with that. So the you ain't get sued for that. Wonder what a sweater might do for that. I could be a shocker where roof is at. 80 in the Benz when that roof go back. They don't wanna see us get too okay. I just got a feeling that we might be friends for a long, long time. You don't mind and you know I like you for that.
Girl, I like you, I do. I wanna be a friend, go shopping in a Benz. I like you, I do. I hit you in a lane, can you fit me in your plans? I like you.
Interesting just hearing how many women out there think they might be married to somebody that's gay. It's just it's pretty insane. The amount of texts that we got, and these are people saying, yeah, you know, yeah, I've been with a guy for many, many years. We don't have a lot of intimacy, but you know, he's a good dude. How do you know? It's really weird. I guess you can ask somebody and they got to be honest. And that's by the way, not cool. If somebody does point blank ask you, are you gay or at least bisexual before we get married, I need to know. And they're not honest with you. That is not a cool thing. You should always be honest, I believe, about your stirrings and your preferences.
Yeah,
totally.
Do not go into a marriage under false pretenses, but it apparently is happening a lot. This is, second email that we've gotten basically on this line and the last 2 weeks. People were asking, too, what about that bridesmaid that you heard from last week? Hopefully we'll get something from her in the next week. So I think she had that wedding coming up. Maybe it was last weekend or maybe this coming weekend. I'm not sure.
They all blend together.
It does. It does all blend together. Oh, but she had said she would let us know what she decided to do.
I forget what year it is. 2022. What is it?
It's difficult.
The After the Show podcast is going to be coming up here. And the only thing I like about politics sometimes is the ridiculous theater of it. And
it's a joke.
There is a dynamic right now that is fascinating to me as former President Donald Trump has declared for the presidency. And here you've got our Florida governor that's kind of waiting in the wings that apparently at one point was, you know, his Robin to Batman. But now Trump realizes that this dude is a threat and a competitor. And he's throwing out some interesting accusations about Governor Ron DeSantis involving teenage girls. We'll get into that coming up in the After the Show podcast. I'll let you know what Donald Trump is claiming of DeSantis, but he's going in, baby.
I can't wait to be non-political with that conversation.
Oh, we can skip it, but it's entertaining. I won't do it. But
No, I won't do it.
There's so much slinging right now. Everybody's slinging at everybody. It's insane.
Look, I think if it's in your heart and your passion, you should do it. I'm just making jokes over here.
I just think it's amusing. And this may be just a taste of how nasty this thing's going to get. So
yeah, man, talk about it.
Okay. So we got that. We got your emails as well coming up here. Mail at kvjshow.com. Send them to us about 10 minutes away. We'll get into the After the Show. Going to be live on Twitch and YouTube. Just look for the KVJ Show. All right. Bird, what you got for your thought for the day?
There are two wolves fighting inside all of us. The first one is evil. The second one is good. Which wolf will win?
Ow, ow, ow.
The one you feed.
That's right. So true. Yeah.
The KVJ Show on 97.9 WRMF.